Lopez getting that last one right at the tail end, sneaking in there, getting that last one on an excellent forecheck, getting the puck, putting it in the back of the net.
Yeah, we'll see what else is in store tonight. We're going to take a timeout, come back with more on the Triple Cities Family Dental pregame show after these messages. You're listening to Black Bears Hockey on Fox Sports 1430.
What is the message to the team?
One game at a time, one shift at a time. Let's focus on the first 5 minutes. I thought we had a sloppy first period, and then we cleaned it up after that. So, one shift at a time, do your role, and focus on your job.
Had a couple new guys in the roster last night, Taylor and Don, making their Black Bear and seasonal debuts, respectively. Neither one of them had played a contest this season at any level of professional hockey. What did you like about those two guys standing out?
I was very surprised. Taylor was great with playing the puck. He obviously had a lot of shots, and he stood tall in that. And then Don, I was very surprised because he hasn't been playing for 8 months. He's been coaching, and just very impressed with his play, his vision, his shot. He really hasn't lost too much being out of the game.
I know that we had talked about Don off the air yesterday a little bit before. He said you got to give him a little bit of time because he's got to shake off some rust. If that's him rusty, I really can't wait to see what he has when he's up to full speed.
Exactly. So when he's on, he's going to be a dominant defenseman in this league. He's a power play specialist, as you saw last night with his shot. And then just his playmaking ability. He might not be the fastest, but he's a pretty crafty player.
And Black Bears are also playing for positioning in the Empire Division with a regulation victory tonight and a regulation loss by the Hat Tricks. The Hat Tricks and Black Bears will be tied at the top in first place. How is it important now every game against these divisional opponents to try to secure those regulation wins?
It's huge. So we got first place on the line, and we could tie it up with Danbury tonight. And that's the main focus. We can't be overlooking teams because there's points on the line, and Columbus could steal three from Danbury. I know they took a couple points last night. So that's the main focus, is just climbing those standings.
All right, Coach, thank you for your time.
Thank you so much, Brooksy.
And that is the voice of interim head coach Brant Sherwood. More to come on the Triple Cities Family Dental pregame show after these messages on Fox Sports 1430 in Binghamton.
Tonight, number 30, Ryan.
Welcome back in. The team's getting ready to take the ice and some anthems to be sung here momentarily. But before we do that, let's go ahead and get to tonight's injuries and scratches for the Black Bears. Alex, brought to you by our friends over at the Court Jester Athletic Club. Just one switch in the lineup, and it'll be Jake Schultz, the captain, drawing back into the lineup in the spot of Justin Coachman, who is just a healthy extra tonight.
Well, when you're a veteran like Coachman or like Schultz, you can get those workload reduction days, you know, vet rest day, save the body for the playoffs. It's a smart move by interim coach Brant Sherwood.
Kyle Powell, Cam Yarwood also out of the lineup tonight with Ian Wallace, the third man in the goalie room right now. I'm going to step aside real quick. We have the presentations of some anthems here inside the arena. Elementary school doing a great job with their presentation of God Bless America, and Waverly High School, of course, performing the national anthem. Waverly High School performing their rendition of the national anthem. They did an excellent job. We're going to step aside, come back with the opening faceoff right here on Fox Sports 1430. Welcome in for Star Wars night in a galaxy far, far away in Binghamton, New York. We are ready to go here. Starting lineups tonight for the Black Bears, it's the Lopez, Ivoskin, and Thompson line that's been so hot of recently. Schultz and Fitzgerald on the blue line, and Riley McVay in the net for the Black Bears, Alex.
Yeah, an excellent line to start it out with. An incredible night from them last night. And Schultz and Fitzgerald are a great line pairing with this line. both Schultz and Fitzgerald can join the rush as an extra forward, which makes them highly advantageous to go with the offensive powerhouse that is Thompson, Ivashkin, and CeeLo. I think you got to start calling this the Gree line, Brooks.
All right, we'll see if it sticks. Pest from the Southwest scored his first hat trick as a member of the Black Bears last night. Three-goal night for Chad Lopez. Got his last one with 6 seconds left to go. And now up to 9 goals on the season in just 7 games played.
And 15 total points. That's 2 points per game player.
Yeah, pretty impressive any way you look at it. Also a guy standing out last night, Don Oliveri, newly acquired defenseman for the Black Bears in the absence of Cam Yardwood, who's out with a knee injury. He had a three-point night as well, 1 goal and 2 assists.
Yeah, Don Oliveri played really well last night, Brooks. Just brings a complete defensive mindset to the game in every area of the ice. And as Binghamton has been doing recently, just another great asset to pick up.
All right, here we go. The opening credits of the hockey game have scrolled. The Black Bears win the faceoff, but it'll be quickly dumped back in by the Delaware Thunder, and we are officially underway for the first ever Binghamton Black Bears Star Wars Night, a tradition that has since loomed through the arena, and we're very excited that the Black Bears organization could bring it back for all the patrons in attendance, many of which are still making their way to the seats in this one. Jacob Wolf tries to throw the puck through the legs of Fitzgerald, and he will succeed. DeConstanzo puts a weak backhander on, but McVay will steer it into the corner. Schultz will send DeConstanzo down to the ice, but the Thunder maintain control. Wolf back over to Rasmus Apps, easily detected by McVay with no net front presence, turns it into the corner, but Delaware with the first 2 shots on goal of the period. Loose puck available, and Wolf is in alone, tries to go off the back of the goaltender, but he gets the side of the net instead.
Yeah, Brooks, that was a really good goal-scoring opportunity for Delaware. Riley Vigneault did not close the pipe. There was an opening there for a goal.
Yeah, and the Black Bears trying to go through the blue line. Instead, they will change out to the top line. Tyler Jurich, Brett Parker, and Gavin Yates occupy the top line right now. A little bit of a line shuffle for Coach Sherwood's club. Don Oliveri paired up with Mathieu Boilard for the second consecutive game. Stretch pass connects with Parker out in front for Yates, but a little bit too hard. Oliveri comes in with a slap shot, and Trevor Martin, starting goaltender tonight for Delaware, got a shoulder to that one and pushed that one into the corner. Malushkin throws a shot, easily saved by McVay, and that puck is cleared down the length of the ice. This will be icing, though, as the Black Bears don't touch it. That's going to come all the way back into the offensive zone.
Yeah, and a good job by Gavin Yates getting back in the defensive rush there, flipping his skates over and playing the second defender to Mathieu Boilard because Oliveri was up on the offensive rush.
18-21 remaining here in the period. As it shows on the board, Delaware leads 3-0 in shots early in this one. Daniluk throws a slap shot, kick save McVay, pushes it all the way back out to the blue line. Hannah Kynan, who had an early exit from the game last night due to a misconduct and some fights, back in the lineup tonight for Coach Santini's club. Black Bears a little sloppy on the passing so far in this one, but they got to get their feet underneath them. Good held by Boilard at the line. That's going to go off the skate of Yates. Stays in play just barely, but Jurich is the first man to it. Skating through the slot, puts a backhander, paddled away by Martin. Martin's played in so many games this year for the Thunder. Had to do a lot of heavy lifting. I have to check the stat on it, and maybe we find out during intermission, but I believe Trevor Martin's played the most games out of any goaltender this year
and
in the FPHL.
Brooks, just a minute ago, Gavin Yates is keeping up his physicality from last night and really over the past 5 or 6 games. He just put Daniel Look on the ice in the corner.
Mac Lewis right in front of the Delaware bench tries to steer the puck down low. It's impeded on the half board by Hannah Kynan, and Hannah Kynan will let it go all the way back for Trevor Martin. Tries to play it around Newberg. This is dangerous for Delaware, but they get it back out to the blue line. Walters holds it in. Walters scoring last Friday night against the Danbury Hat Tricks, his first goal of the season. We talked to him yesterday during the Excite Motorsports first period intermission interview. 3 minutes gone here in this one. Black Bears still searching for a shot. Delaware with the first 4 in this one. Thunder coming out a little bit advantageous in this one, trying to end their losing streak tonight here at Binghamton. Now crossing over the line, and a shot put on by Gafaroff as Newberg loses his stick. Mac Lewis tries to throw the puck out of the zone. It'll bounce off of a Delaware defender back out into neutral ice where the Thunder touch up. Black Bears in a line change. Puck not real deep enough, but they get all five out on the ice. A wrist shot from Malushkin, I believe, is deflected off of the stick of JT Walters and put into the safety netting and out of play.
Yeah, Brooks, an excellent job by keeping that net clean, forcing Delaware to take those wide chances from non-prime real estate locations. An excellent job so far defensively from the Black Bears.
Houston Wilson getting a first look at him in the faceoff dot going up against Chad Lopez. We've seen Lopez and Thompson switch a couple of times throughout last night about who's going to take a faceoff basing on the handiness of one another. Thompson tries to get it out of the zone. Lopez a lefty, Thompson a righty, so we might see that. Malushkin in the slot throws a shot, and Delaware is on the board first.
Yeah, Malushkin, big selly there, Brooks. Really excited about that goal, and the Delaware Thunder get on the board first. It's going to be interesting to see, though. Delaware out shooting the Black Bears 6-0 right now. Is the problem that's plagued the Black Bear all year long of slow starts after big victories going to plague them again? So far, you have to think so.
Yeah, 3:47 game time. That goal, Daniil Malushkin.
Lopez with a huge hit, Brooks.
Yeah, we'll see if the Black Bears have a quick response. Passes out in front, stays out of the net. So Rasmus Asp and Dennis Gafferoff get the assist. It's an even strength goal. Delaware up 1-0. Black Bears finally get their first shot on goal.
Risky pass there, Brooks.
Yeah, and the Black Bears put a shot on. Fitzgerald throws it into the chest of the goaltender, and Martin fumbled with it but dives on top of it to melt it down. 15:40 left to go here in the period.
Yeah, Brooks, you can tell that starting line really took it personally, that goal. Lopez with a big hit at the blue line. Lots of good offensive chances. It seems like that line has woken up a little bit. Let's see if every other line follows suit.
Yates will lose the faceoff, and Moritz will try to steer it away over to Delaney on the backhand. Brett Parker's moving with a lot of speed right now. And they're going to say this was touched at the line by Mattu Boylar, so that will nullify the icing. Parker's at the blue line, gets the puck out of the zone. Delaware is touching up right now. They're back on sides, and Boylar will chase after it. Matched up with Oliveri. Oliveri with a nice pass between the legs of a forward, and that'll allow the Black Bears to go 3-on-2. Gavin Yates cutting through Main Street, circling around, low angle shot. It's off of, I believe, the neck protector of Trevor Martin, and Winstrom coming out the other way. Olivieri lost an edge, and he's just going to hook a man. We're going to see if they're going to point to the dot, and this will be the game's first penalty. It's going to go to Don Oliveri, 2 for hooking.
Yeah, an unfortunate one for Oliveri, Brooks, but one you're not, if you're Coach Branch, interim Coach Branch Sherwood, you're not super angry about, just because he caught an edge going over the blue line, goes down. The Delaware forward would have had a one-on-one shot to the net. He gets his stick up into the jersey, pulls him down. 2 minutes on the penalty kill, but you know what? You have to understand that one's a real goal-saving opportunity.
Yeah, we're going to talk about it when we come back. 14:56 left to go here in the first period. Delaware up 1-0 on Fox Sports, 14:30. Black Bears are on the Northeastern Striping Corporation penalty kill. They came into the weekend operating at 84%. Delaware scored 2 power play goals last night. Their first even strength goal of the weekend series has the Thunder up by 1. Black Bears will win the faceoff thanks to Josh Newberg, and Schultz will slap it down the length of the ice.
Well, and with Brooks, how hard Schultz just hit that. Honestly, it took Martin a little bit to hold, which killed a lot of time.
Rasmus Ass touches up at the line just to get it deep, but that'll allow the Black Bears to get control of the puck. Fitzgerald running out of real estate, so he knows the wise thing is just to play it off the glass, get it out of the zone. Got some fresh bodies out on the ice for the Black Bears. Not too tired yet. 30 seconds in to this penalty kill. Forwards are Kirkby and Newberg, and Newberg hounding Daniluk in his own end right now. Malushkin, the goal scorer, with the puck, and Delaware not being able to move up ice. Uncontested so far, forcing an errant pass. Schultz with a tight turn and will glide it down the length of the ice once again. And now four new bodies coming out for the Black Bears.
Yeah, and that's a tough save for Martin as well. That comes in with a little bit of speed, not able to hold that like you wish.
Lewis does a good job deflecting a Malushkin pass outside the zone. Delaware touches up in neutral ice. And now Vinstrom coming down the left wing side, glides over to Ivanov. They play catch. Vinstrom down low to Wilson. Wilson, turnaround shot. Good bounce back save from Riley McVay. Black Bears still chasing after the puck. 40 seconds left to go. They work it down low to Wilson. Wilson fakes the Michigan, passes out in front. Ass on the backhand is cleared off of the crease and thrown down the length of the ice by Boylard.
Tell you what, Brooks, the physicality is keeping up. Mac Lewis dumped the Malushkin right in front of his bench about a minute into this penalty kill.
Eric Molesso crossing over the line, dumps it ahead for Gafferoff. Gafferoff throws on the brakes, and that'll force Molesso and the Butcher to come in contact with each other. And look out, shorthanded breakaway. Austin Thompson. And we have a penalty coming up at the end of the play. Behind it, Taylor Cutting is going to get called for a slash. And he's headed to the penalty box, and Delaware is going to have 10 seconds of 5-on-3. I did not see that play, Alex, not going to lie. I was watching Thompson go shorthanded the other way. Going to wonder if we even have an angle on that on the Heinz Energy replay.
Yeah, Brooks, that was really behind the play. It looks like Cutting is showing a stick mark on his own foot from a plate. I could see it up here. There's a nice white mark right across the toe of his skate. There's a little bit of red.
6:54 time in the penalty. Black Bears just need to win this faceoff. Throw it down the length of the ice. There it is. That's
I've seen a lot of slashes that got called this year, Brooks. That was probably the lightest we've seen so far.
Black Bears are back on the Northeastern Striping Corporation penalty kill, but they get Oliveri back, so Delaware is officially 0-for-1 on the power play so far. See what the Black Bears can do here. Maybe this is what they need to wake them up a little bit, have to stay disciplined, playing down a man, and maybe we'll give them an offensive energized boost. Josh Newberg chasing after a puck all by himself down low. Kirkby coming, and the centering pass is denied. Newberg couldn't get anything that he really wanted on that one, but a great back check from Tyson Kirkby. Thought he forced Delaware offsides. Crowd's going to moan about it. Vinstrom, pass over to Malesko. One-timer, and McVay comes across the crease to make the save.
And an excellent job by JT Walters and Newberg getting down in front of those shots and eliminating easier opportunities. Forced Delaware to lift that puck up and pass, make a pass right on the doorstep. Good job by the Black Bears defense. You got to think, though, Newberg is going to be mad at himself for that one. I think he thought he had that one alone and could have got it to Kirkby for a goal.
Thompson wins the faceoff to himself, and that'll send Nikita Ivashkin in for a skate race. Ivashkin, ton of speed on the back end. Power move in front, wide of the target. Black Bears are starting to generate a little bit more offense shorthanded than they had at even strength, Alex.
Yeah, Brooks, an excellent job. A lot of energy here from the penalty kill.
Ivashkin down low, loses an edge. And that time, not going to be able to sell a tripping call right there. A lot of speed turning around the post like that. Ivashkin down on his own accord. Deacon stands across the line by himself, wraps it all the way back over for Andre Ivanov. Down low to Wilson outside the left faceoff dot. Deacon stands a power move to the front, paddled down by McVay. Walters trying to get to Thompson for a loose puck, centered it right in front of his own net. A look out. Malushkin.
Yeah, I think that one fluttered on him, Brooks. He was trying to get a high shot and get that down, and just jumped off his stick weird.
Malushkin loads it up for Ivanov, and a one-timer. They score on the power play. Delaware's up 2-0. And they're 1-for-2 on the power play tonight with 11:15 left to go.
And the cost and the slashing by Taylor Cutting proves costly. Brooks, an incredibly good shot from Ivanov, who just got it through 2-3 players out in front, screening Riley McVeigh.
And I take a look at the high energy replay. Maluskin, a little bit of a head fake, sets up Ivanov for the one-timer, and it gets past Riley McVeigh. Delaware up 2-0 on the road. It's a power play goal by Andre Ivanov, and Maluska now looking at a two-point night with the primary helper. Don't know if they're going to give out a secondary assist from that one. I know the Black Bears tried to exit the zone. But on Star Wars night, it's the Rebels from Delaware who are on top of the Empire, being the Black Bears. Daniluk throws a shot. McVeigh steers that one into the side. It's now in the corner for Jacob Wolf. Wolf circling the wagon. And the Black Bears go the other way. Breakaway for Tyler Jurich. And all alone, he scores, and the Black Bears are on the board. Tyler Jurich, all by himself.
What an excellent play from Tyler Jurich and Colin Fitzgerald there. Fitzgerald jumps on the loose puck, uses his momentum to just slide it out to Jurich. Jurich buries it over the blocker of Martin. 2-1 game, Black.
It's an even straight goal. Tyler Jurich will continue to creep closer. And Fitzgerald saw that Jurich was behind the defense. Excellent pass from Colin. Binghamton is on the board. Now we'll see what kind of boost this gives the home team. And Malesso, going through the slot, throws a slap shot on. McVeigh holds that one on, and that's a defensive breakdown for the Black Bears, but they get bailed out by their goaltender right there.
Yeah, a really good cycle by Melso there to work all the way through the defense, and a switch happened that clearly the second part of the switch did not get the message on, as Melso gets a wide open shot from a prime real estate location.
Be an offensive zone faceoff for the Delaware Thunder. One back, Mortz throws a shot that's turned aside by McVeigh. Black Bears playing with a little bit more pep in their step, but we're gonna have a hand pass violation called. We're gonna have a neutral zone faceoff just almost halfway through the period.
Going to center ice, Brooks. Yeah, and you know, with the Black Bears, to get back into this, they need to get their shots up. It's 13-5 Delaware right now. Delaware's dominating the offensive zone possession time as well. Black Bears need to get their shots up. They need to get more chances on net.
Center ice faceoff is won back by Houston Wilson. He does that very well. And seeing a couple guys lose their edge here early on. Ast throws a shot, and McVeigh will hold on right in the chest of the goaltender.
An excellent job by McVeigh just swallowing that one up. Take the draw, which the Black Bears are very good when they win the draw. They are really good at setting up their set plays and getting breakout plays from their own zone.
Let's see what they do here. Alex Wilson and Lopez going right back with each other. Faceoff is going to be pushed back to the wingers. Thought that might have been played with a high stick, but they say to play on. Thompson chips it ahead for Lopez. Lopez centers up for Ivashkin in the slot, and Martin makes a save. Rebounds available. Goaltenders down in the splits. And Black Bears with a golden opportunity to tie the game up. Walters holds it in at the line, but he throws it off his own teammate. Black Bears try to touch back up as they fight for the puck in front of both benches. Maluskin on the pass, and Gafarov heard the footsteps coming from Oliveri. Walters will just get the puck from behind. They're on some tight turns. Try to throw it out of the zone, but a little bit too far in front of his teammate. And the Thunder retake possession.
Yeah, Brooks, a great job by Oliveri as well to hold up on that hit and not hit a man without the puck.
Look out. Weber coming in. McVeigh makes the save. Rebound is available. Oliveri had the puck hop over his stick. Delaware was in alone. And now 2-on-1 going the other way. Lewis with Newberg. Over to Newberg. He scores! Josh Newberg! Tie game at 2.
An excellent job there by the Black Bears forwards getting up the ice. Lewis, a good job of recognizing, you know what, Newberg got a better angle, I'm going to get on his stick. And Newberg buries in the back of the net for the goal.
Right, that save down from Riley McVeigh, who just stopped that earlier one after it hopped the stick of Oliveri. Black Bears go the other way. Mac Lewis with the assist. Josh Newberg on the 2-on-1, and we are tied at 2 here. Just under 9 minutes remaining in the period. Josh Newberg ties the game up.
And an interesting thing there, Brooks, on the Heinz Energy replay, I just noticed Mac Lewis did a great job in following his pass. He got it to Newberg, but set himself up to get the rebound if it hopped off a post or anything like that.
11:02, time of the goal for the Black Bears, and now Rasmus Apps tries to reclaim the lead for the Thunder as he throws a shot looking for a tip. Puck is jumbling all around like a pinball machine. Out in front of Riley McVeigh's net, Lewis will get the red line and no further and dump it in. Asp in the corner.
Boylar and Delaney mixing it up in the defensive zone of the Black Bears.
Look out, another chance for Tyler Jurich. In and out of the glove. Yates takes a baseball whack at it. This puck is going to be flipped up high. And for the second night in a row, the scoreboard has been hit by a Delaware player trying to clear the puck out of the zone.
Man, I'll tell you what, Brooks, that sound, you see it and you're like, oh, is this going to happen? Perfectly hitting the scoreboard. It seems, you know, it reminds me of being in when we were up in Watertown in our utility stairwell, where we thought a few times that puck was coming to us.
Yeah, we did, and you know, it's kind of funny that Delaware's throwing the puck off of the video board here tonight inside Vision Veterans Memorial Arena at their home rink, which they do a good job of filling out night in and night out. A small barn, but it does get loud with all the fans on one side of the ice. The ceilings aren't that high, so that puck would have gone off of the ceiling, bounced around all the rafters, and then you have no idea where it's going to go. So funny that they've hit the scoreboard two nights in a row.
Well, Brooks, it's almost like, to quote Step Brothers here, they have so much more space for activities. You know, maybe they're thinking they're not used to being able to, so they want to try to test out the height and figure out where it's going. You know you're saying
that to a Kraken fan. Take a time. We're gonna take a timeout, come back with more after these messages on Fox Sports 1430 in Binghamton.
One more time.
Don't forget to head to Section 1 after tonight's contest for the Star Wars jersey post-game auction benefiting the Southern Tier Hockey Association.
Hey, Riley, they're getting ready to start early, so we're just gonna talk and then we'll reach our cue in back when the commercial's in. All right, thank you. No, you can. I'll say it. Thank you. Gavin Yates
wins the draw there, Brooks.
Oh yeah. He won it back cleanly, but unfortunately intercepted right away by the Delaware Thunder. But they're trading it back in. Pawed down by Schultz. He turns it over to Malushkin. Out in front for Wilson. Tries to go to the back door. Power move, and McVeigh holds the post for our friends joining us back from the radio side. A good save by Riley McVeigh keeps this game squared at 2. Didn't miss much, though, just about a couple 10 seconds. And McVeigh holds on, and we're going to have an offensive zone faceoff coming up. 7:47 left to go, and Yates will win that one over Wilson. Black Bears try to run the same stretch play that sprung Tyler Jurich for the Black Bears' first goal of the contest. And right now, Black Bears picking up the pace in the second half of the period, but Delaware, with the early start of this one, got up on the board 2-0. Since then, the Black Bears have tied the game up at 2. They're also being outshot 16-8 at home in the first period. That's also the most shots that Delaware's put up in a period against the Black Bears this year. Penalties coming up, and Gavin Yates comes in to lay a hit after the play. We'll see if the discipline can sink in here. Black Bears would love the opportunity to play 5-on-4 and not 4-on-4 here.
Yeah, Brooks, it was Weber all the way. Got him up, got Colin Fitzgerald high with a high stick. Went for a stick check. Unfortunately for him, Fitzgerald turned right when he was about to do it and just caught him up high, which Gavin Yates was not a fan of.
Looks like we're going to send Austin Weber to the penalty box. Delaware's first penalty of the game since the leading power play of the FPHL. Out onto the ice entering the weekend, just under 25%. Black Bears did score one time last night on the power play. Excuse me, check that, they scored twice. Don Oliveri and Austin Thompson. No, three times. Thompson with two power play goals. My notes were wrong. Apologize. Three power play goals last night for the Black Bears, so we'll see if they can continue it here tonight. One back to Oliveri. Trade places with Tyler Jurich. Oliveri throws a tip out in front. Lewis hammers a rebound, but steered into the corner. Yates stays with the puck right in front of the Alexander Cafe door. Oliveri goes D to D with Tyler Jurich. And Oliveri a little bit too soft on that pass here. Loaded up. Over for Jurich. Into the slot for Kirkby. Fanned on it. A little bit too far out in front for Tyson, but Yates to the rebound. Black Bears keeping the puck in the offensive zone so far through the first 30 seconds. Oliveri throws a shot. Rebound's tied up. Kirkby wants a call. He's not going to get one. Tyler Jurich is getting on his horse back defensively. Here come the Thunder shorthanded. Shot high over the blocker of McVay. Didn't connect with anything. And Gavin Yates, stretch pass over for Kirkby. To himself, he's on sides. Backhander, he scores. Bar down. Tyson Kirkby let the crowd know. What a power play goal, and Binghamton has the lead.
And you know what Kirkby's got to say to the officials there? All right, you're not going to call the holding call there, but I'll bury in the back of the net and take this power play over. Shut it down. Excellent job by Tyson Kirkby. Had it on his forehand. Quickly switched it to his backhand. Upper corner, an excellent job. Such a hard spot to put that puck. And it's 3-2 Black Bears. Black Bears down 16-12 in the shots category.
What a pass to himself from Tyson Kirkby to allow him to be on sides. That Heinzer injury replay doesn't do it justice, folks. Black Bears are on top for the first time tonight. They lead 3-2. Here's Frank Perney. That goal is going to be washed out. Going to stay here. Delaware is going to boo that one. That puck was still available, and the referee might have just bailed out the Black Bears.
An interesting one there, boys.
Referee's right on top of it. They say no goal. Black Bears come away. That would have given Delaware a tied game up at 3. 5 goals in this first period on Star Wars night. Austin Thompson flying in like an X-Wing. And now Hannah Kynan down low will clear the puck out of the zone. They're going to say it's tipped. Oliveri trying to plead with the official. I don't know from my angle. It looked like it was tipped. Anytime the puck starts to go end over end, that's normally an indication.
Yeah, 100%, Brooks. And Don Oliveri, you can see through this first period why interim coach Grant Sherwood went after him. Such a good passer of the puck.
And Eric Malesko, self-pass around Oliveri. McVay coming out of his net will throw the poke check. Steered the puck into the corner. I believe Malesko lost his stick in the process. Piece of driftwood floating out. And now Ivoskin through the slot, trying to get to his forehand. But Oliveri will throw a pass over the stick of Chad Lopez. And Fitzgerald coming all the way back into his zone to collect the loose puck. They try to connect on the home run play, but instead they're just dumping in down low, get some line changes through the forward groups. Lopez still out there. Kirkby with Ivoskin. Fitzgerald and Schultz. Gaffer off. Tight turn around Ivoskin. Turning it over right to Tyson Kirkby with the hot stick for Ivoskin in the slot. Easily decided by Martin. And a second chance from Lopez is held up against the post by the Delaware goaltender.
And Ivanov just buried Ivoskin there. The IVI for first run goes to Ivanov.
Tyson Kirkby held it in at the blue line, backhands it over to Ivoskin. Doesn't get everything that he wants, and a hit that sent Ivoskin down to the ice. Good thing Nikita's okay. Line's been picking up a
That's Melso's stick from earlier.
Yep. Josh Newberg, Mac Lewis, and Tyson Kirkby. Now, this line already has 2 goals tonight. Or is responsible for 2. Another puck flipped up high in the air. This time it doesn't hit the scoreboard. Leads to a partial 2-on-1, but Gafferoff doesn't make the pass. Puts it on target, and McVay swallows up. 4:51 left to go here in this one. Black Bears have a 3-2 advantage over the Delaware Thunder. More to come after these messages on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton. We ask you to please rise.
as American Electric, the Black Bears, and all of our fans, thank you for your sacrifices and services.
And they can't take that away.
Welcome back to the action. Brooksville and Alex Jones on the call tonight. And we're going to have ringside reporter Cole Parenti talking to Tyson Kirkby as soon as we get done with the first period. So Cole did a great job last night filling in for Alex on color in his first time on the Black Bears Sports Network, and we really appreciate the time that he's been putting in with the Black Bears in the front office as an intern, a student over at BU. And how do you think that your fill-in did, Alex?
I thought he did an excellent job for his first time. He did a really, really good job, sounded great on commentary.
Newberg and Wilson will face off as Malushkin gets to the loose puck on the wind from Delaware, thrown all the way around the boards, and Wilson overplayed that puck a little bit. Kirkby wanted to throw it out of the zone immediately, but instead waits up for his teammates, throws it in cross corner for Josh Newberg, centering out in front, and Kirkby, I don't think, was expecting that pass to be right in front of the goal mouth. Schultz holding the line temporarily. They work it down low to Newberg. Newberg back to the point, thinking that Fitzgerald was going to be there to pinch. Instead, it was a Delaware member. And some of the guys joking in the locker room that the Star Wars jerseys tonight look a lot like Delaware's home jerseys. A lot of same color schemes. Fitzgerald with a lot of speed out in front. Puck is available, side of the goal. Kirkby gets to it, and they circle behind the net.
Pretty close to an own goal there, Brooks.
Out in front for Yates, off the bar. Held in by Schultz. Kirkby turn around. Martin makes a save, rebound, and another stuff chance is denied by Trevor Martin. He's already seen 15 shots here in this one as the Black Bears look to tie up the shots on goal count. We're getting to the Columbia Mutual Life's stats and go through everything when we get to the Excite Motorsports intermission report. Out in front for Yates, and Martin makes another save right on the doorstep. The Black Bears could have had two goals this offensive shift, and finally DeConstanzo gets the puck over the red line. And Delaware puts himself offside. They have to retreat into their own zone, but a great sequence, perhaps the best of the game so far for the Black Bears.
Yeah, Mac Lewis with an excellent job holding the puck behind the net.
Tipped in by the Thunder, and McVay sets it up on a tee for D'Angelo. D'Angelo on that third defensive pairing with JT Walters tonight. Well, that puck is turned over. Held on, though, by McVay on the wrist shot from Austin Weber.
Yeah, Brooks, a good save by McVay there. Quick turnover in the offense, in the defensive zone, right by the circle, right by the BA systems, and just an excellent chance at a goal.
Ideal Bowling Center is where Binghamton hockey fans bowl with open bowling all week long. Money-saving specials. Ideal is a great place for family, friends, company parties, and special occasions. Ideal Bowling Center, 119 Jennings Street, Endicott. So much more than just your favorite bowling alley. And
Yeah, Brooks, and Delaware wins the draw, gets a quick shot. McVay swallows it up, melts it down.
Now we're reset, do it all again. Took about 2 seconds off the clock. 3:03 left to go here in the first period. Five goals in the period between the two sides. Delaware gets the first two, and the Black Bears get the final three so far. A lot of time left to go. Here comes Gavin Yates. A lot of speed, gets around Asp. Jurich looking for Yates on the back door, has his pass blocked. Brett Parker gets to a loose puck, tries to center up for Yates, slaps one out in front. Jurich runs into the goaltender, takes a couple of hits, pushed down. Gavin Yates will take exception to that. And now we're going to have some fisticuffs. Jurich gets slashed. Brett Parker and Delaney. No, that's Moritz. Walters and Ass. Walters is trying to get to Rasmus Ass as much as he can. He's getting restrained.
Yeah, and Church's shoulder is injured on the play. Upper body injury for Church. He takes the bench. And I'm going to be honest here. That, it was a nasty hit to Church down to the bottom of that pile. He's headed straight to the locker room.
Tyler Jurich, not a guy you want to go down for the Black Bears. They're also going to send JT Walters to the locker room.
And Brett Parker.
I didn't see anybody exit for the Thunder. They're sending Rasmus Ass to the penalty box. Going to be interesting how they're going to sort this one out as our video crew following the team into the locker room. Here's the Hines energy replay. So Jurich gets into the crease. Makes incidental contact, then gets pushed down on top of the goaltender. And then Jurich.
Reaching up there, Brooks. It looks like he grabs for and immediately grabs for his arm. Upper, it looks like it's going to be an upper body injury for Jurich.
And then now you're seeing JT Walters trying to get a hold of Rasmus Ass, and the linesmen have to get in between that altercation.
It's interesting they sent Parker as well to the locker room with no one for Delaware going to.
Yeah, you just see Jurich when he reached up, something happened. So we're going to see how this one's going to get sorted out. We ran out of spots in the penalty column last night in the scorebook, Alex. We had 24, at least by my count. I could have had more, but at 24, I stopped writing.
Yeah, and Brooks, it a lot of chatter happening right now on the bench between the two teams. It's going to be interesting who's
the
head of
the
box.
The time is now
so we've got
to stand
Nelso.
Up, dig down deep, and make some noise.
So they're going to send two guys to the box for Delaware. They sent two guys to the locker room for Binghamton. Kirkby and Weber trying to get an explanation from the official. This is one of those moments you wish that the referees were mic'd up.
Yeah, Brooks, it looks like our off-ice official down in the penalty box is taking almost like a whole lunch order down rather than a penalty call. It's going to be interesting, though, Brooks, when you have somebody like Jurich get hit like that, ending up with an injury as a result of the entire practice, how does your team respond? Will they wilt? Because what they saw one of their best guys go to the locker room worrying about that guy? Or are they going to respond to it? Are they going to come out, slam the door shut? We are at, Brooks, a monumental shot total for the first period. 19 shots for Delaware, 18 shots for Binghamton with 2:40 left in the first period. I think this is the most shots I have seen personally as a commentator for the Black Bears. In one period.
So we're going to stay at 5-on-5, so nobody gains an advantage. Boylar putting on a tight turn at center ice. Austin Thompson tries to keep the puck in temporarily. Knocked out of the air with a stick below the shoulders from Ivoshkin. Lopez and Wilson fight for each other's skates and push back out into neutral ice. Oliveri calls his own number, goes around one man. Low angle shot, easily saved by the goaltender. Now we're tied 19 apiece. Shots on goal in the first period.
And O'Reilly gave Ivoshkin a little bit of a shot.
Yep, and it looks like the Black Bears are going to head to the Northeastern Striping Corporation penalty kill again as Boylar with the extra whack. Remember what they say,
yeah,
Alex. It's never the first guy. It's always the second.
It is, Brooks, but that was a Charmin call right there. It's extra soft. That was a ridiculous one. It was a shove after play 100%. It's also a response to Riley, who gave a shove to Ivoshkin after the play. So it's kind of like you got to sometimes let the guys play. It's not outside. It's not incredibly outside the letter of the law. But the officials so far have been calling a tighter game on the physicality side.
Yeah, so they're going to probably give Boylar the 2 for slashing, and then he gets a 10 misconduct.
Could be a 10, Brooks, but I might be a 2. Might be a 2-minuter.
Well, if it was a 2, I think they would have him in the box and not the locker room.
No, because it's a 4. That would be your – or do you serve – That's so, Brooks, I'm going to be honest with you. That's my weakest area of hockey is how you dish out the penalties. Is it considered essentially a concurrent sentence where you're serving the two-minute misconduct and the two-minute penalty? Or is it a like a double minor, essentially, but you serve the 2 minutes still sitting in the penalty box?
We're going to see how the official announcement reads. One of the off-ice officials passing a slip of paper over to Frank Perney, so the official announcement probably coming in a couple of seconds.
But Brooks, the Black Bears have shot themselves in the foot too many times tonight by going onto the penalty kill for some invalid reasons.
Danilek throws a slap shot on, and it's going to be wide of the target. Schultz to the rebound, throws it down the length of the ice, and the Black Bears will clear the puck out of the zone. And Black Bears bench, Alex, thinning out here at the final stretch of the first period. A couple of guys already in the locker room. Jurich in there with an injury. Two guys were sent to the locker room as Frank Perney. So they give Ass 5 for fighting. They should have sent him to the locker room.
Delaware penalty number 5, Eric Melso, 2 minutes for roughing at 17:20. That's Melso, 2 minutes for roughing at 17:20.
All right.
Big 10 penalties, number 22, Tyler Jurich. 2 minutes for goalie interference.
They give Jurich 2 for goalie interference.
That's
7:20. That's very odd. Didn't see that penalty come up.
Pennington penalty number 24, JT Walters. 5 minutes for fighting at 17:20. That's Walters, 5 minutes for fighting.
That makes sense.
So then I'm guessing they're going to get Parker in 2 minutes.
Pennington number 28, Matthew Boilar. 2 minutes for cross-checking and 2 minutes for unsportsmanlike conduct.
Okay.
And a game misconduct.
2 for unsportsmanlike and 10 for game misconduct. 18:30, those time and the penalties.
Number 20, Taylor Cutting.
And Taylor Cutting's going to serve those 4 minutes of penalty time.
So why is Parker in the locker room?
Might have missed that one on the read. Call from the official. Delaware should not be able to. No, excuse me. Binghamton can't change right here because that puck was dumped in front of the red line. Or behind the red line.
Well, I mean, if I'm Coach Brant Sherwood, I'm trying to get Parker on the ice. He's not officially on the stat sheet read out yet. Not that we've heard anyways. Perhaps it's a one that they're still processing the penalty of. But
the only penalty in right now is the Boilar roughing. So they're in the process of getting those on right now. So a little bit behind, faceoff is put on. McVay steers it into an open spot, and the Black Bears throw it down the length of the ice. 1 minute remaining in the period. Black Bears are down one man on the Northeastern Striping Corporation penalty kill. They are 1-for-2. Delaware does have a power play goal early in this one. Weber dancing around one Black Bear, gets it down to Vinstrom. Vinstrom over to Weber. Weber dancing around Ivoshkin. We didn't see him play shorthanded last night. Good to see Nikita back out there on the special teams unit again tonight. 30 seconds left to go in the period. Delaware holding for the right shot, trying to tie this game up going into the room. Vinstrom, bar down, he scores, and that's exactly what he does. Delaware ties it up in the final 30 seconds of the period, and we're all square at 3.
And Brooks, you know, that double minor is going to really affect the Black Bears here because it's 2 minutes, 10 seconds left in that penalty. Meaning it drops down to just 2 minutes. That goal goes in 10 seconds later, 11 seconds later, then it's completely off the board.
Ollie Vinstrom gets another power play goal. Delaware connects twice as that puck comes way out of the zone early. Looks like everybody's okay.
Landed right in CC in section 14.
And looks like a fan's going home with a souvenir. More importantly, everybody's okay. Black Bears are still a man down. That does take the double minor to Matu Boilar down to 2 minutes. So it does kill off 40 seconds of time, but you're now in a tied game at 3 after a very exciting opening 20 minutes, no matter what team you're pulling for, completely different than last night.
100%, Brooks. Almost the complete opposite of last night. Scoring explosion. You have to wonder, though, are all these penalties really drawing out with the Black Bears having that shortened bench early, you mentioned earlier, these penalty kills are gonna, if they continue to take penalties at this rate, it is going to really affect what is happening with this Black Bears team, as you're gonna dwindle down your pool of eligible players for penalty kill to essentially no one.
All right, as the Black Bears make their way off of the ice, our ringside reporter, Cole Parenti, is getting ready to stand by with Tyson Kirkby. It looks like Cole's ready. So, Cole, go ahead and take it away.
All right, guys, I'm here with the forward Tyson Kirkby. Tyson, you had a big goal in that third period, a beautiful backhander. Can you walk me through it from your perspective?
I got open coming down the wing there. JT, good pass, a little soft, had to make an adjustment on the fly, but was able to pick it up, and I didn't have a whole lot on that angle, just trying to get it up over his shoulder, and thank God it went in. I needed that one.
Tyson, one more before I let you go. You guys go down 2-0 in the period, but you're able to battle back and eventually seize the lead. How are you guys able to turn the tide on Delaware?
Yeah, I think that's kind of been our identity all year. You know, we've had some slow starts, you know, the game against Port Huron going down early, but we battle back. We're a resilient group. We don't let it bother us, and we just keep putting our foot down, and we're scoring right now, so we got to keep it going.
Thanks, Tyson. Good luck the rest of the way.
All right, that is Cole Parenti talking with Tyson Kirkby. Thank you, Tyson, and thank you, Cole, for taking a couple minutes out before Tyson heads back into the locker room. We come back, we're going to have the Excite Motorsports intermission report coming up after these messages on Fox Sports 1430. Black Bears will take on the Danbury Hattricks on Friday, February 17th at 7 p.m. We invite everyone to stay for a post-game skate, so bring your skates to the arena and get your tickets now at binghamtonblackbears.com. We can't wait to see you out there on the ice. Black Bear fans, it's now time for the Bricks Barber Company Clip of the Week. And now Ivoskin one-on-one. Penalty time is up. Backhander stuff. Chancey scores! Nikita Ivoskin, what a goal! He beats the goalie to the post. It's an even strength goal. It won't matter how you ride it. Ivoskin, second of the night.
Bricks Barber Company, located in the number 5.
Don't settle for less. Ask for American Standard Heating and Air Conditioning. American Standard, built to a higher standard.
If you're looking to install a beautiful, durable, and handcrafted countertop, call Alice James Construction. The Southern Tier's most trusted stone fabrication will design and install your dream countertop and let you choose from a premium selection of natural stones like marble, granite, or quartzite. Stone or granite countertops starting as low as $35 per square foot installed. Schedule your free quote and receive a free sink with your countertop project. Call 607-275-5495.
We'll be right back. make me think of good things.
Good day.
Like calming tempers down.
Good day.
And passing them around.
So stand up and cheer. We'll pass you a beer.
Good day.
Share a good-natured Canadian Pilsner.
Are you looking for a new place to live? Lofts at JC is the official housing partner of the Binghamton Black Bears and the only luxury housing provider offering both two and three bedroom units fully furnished for a modern living lifestyle. Lofts at JC is centrally located in the heart of the Tri-Cities area, located at 128 Grand Avenue in Johnson City. Housing applications are accepted online at loftsatjc.com. Once again, that's loftsatjc.com.
Magic 101.7.
Best radio station. Keeps getting better.
Better music selection.
Best ever. Makes me feel better.
Number one for music and fun.
It's like the best ever.
Magic 101.7. 100% local.
A wreck is a wreck. An arrest is an arrest. Alcohol, cough syrup, painkillers, sleeping pills. It doesn't matter. Impaired is impaired. And it will be prosecuted. Going out tonight? Your local police will be out too. Don't drive. Get a ride. Brought to you by your New York State Stop DWI program.
The Black Bears return to the ice on February 17th to take on their rival, the Danbury Hattricks. American Special Hockey Association will be in attendance and tabling around the concourse, so make sure to stop by their tables and enter in some of their raffle items, and you can find out more information about the American Special Hockey Association on their website, specialhockey.org.
Into the slot, and Kirby scores on the one-timer.
You do not want to miss 1 minute of Binghamton Black Bear action this upcoming season. With individual game tickets as low as $10 and outstanding group rates, there is no reason to wait to get your tickets to book your group. Call 607-722-7367 or check us out online at binghamtonblackbears.com. Fans, the Binghamton Black Bears are partnering with the Broome Tioga Workforce of New York for the 23rd Annual Career Fair. It'll be Friday, February 17th between 2:30 and 5:30 p.m. right here inside Vision Veterans Memorial Arena. Bring your resume to the Career Fair and receive a free ticket to the Black Bears game that evening. We can't wait to see you on February 17th.
Welcome back to the second period presented by Lofts at JC. The official housing partners of the Binghamton Black Bears, and the Black Bears find themselves still playing shorthanded for about the next 90 seconds, Alex.
Yeah, Brooks, a really unadvantageous position to put yourself in to start out the period.
Oh, nope, they do change it. I was right. Ollie Vinstrom does get the goal and not Austin Weber. So it's 18's goal and not. And Mac Lewis with a scoring change as well while we were away at intermission. As they get ready to drop the puck here, looks like I misplaced one of my red pen that I'm trying to use to color coordinate. I have found it. Black Bears get to the loose puck. Try to wrap it out of the zone. Kirkby chips it over. Malushkin coming down shorthanded, but puts it behind the goal line with that fresh ice. That puck is going to glide for a long time. Kirkby will not put a shot on and instead play prevent, putting it all the way back for Jake Schultz, who throws it out of the zone. Delaware still offsides, so they had to touch up. Couldn't contest Fitzgerald at the line. Puck never got deep enough.
Honestly, Fitzgerald could have held it there, Brooks, for a few more seconds because there was Delaware players still very deep in the zone.
Delaware puts the puck out of the zone off an errant pass. Goes off the kick plate and all the way around the boards. 34 seconds left to go in the Matu Boilar penalty being served by Taylor Cutting. Boilar has received an ejection from tonight's game for abuse of officials and also verbal abuse of officials as well. A wrist shot looking for a tip. I believe Wilson got a piece of it, but he put it wide. Weber through the faceoff dot and traffic. McVay makes the save at the top of his crease. Schultz gets to the rebound, cleans it up. 10 seconds left to go. Taylor Cutting starts to make his way up to his feet. Standing at the door. Penalty time is up, and we return to 5-on-5 action. Delaware does not score on the final portion of the double minor at the time to Boilar. Oliveri takes a look down the ice, and we're going to see with the Black Bears with a shortened bench. The good thing is Walters now in the box. Parker on the bench. Jurich in the locker room. We'll see if we can get an update on that a little bit later on in tonight's contest. But for right now, Tyler Jurich is not on the team bench. Shot is blocked from the point off the stick of Daniluk by Ivashkin. Black Bears swarming the puck like a herd of cats. They try to center it up in front. Paddle down by McVay. Puck still available. Daniluk gets to a rebound. Throws a shot looking for a tip. Delaney doesn't get enough on it.
Dangerous opportunity there, Brooks. That was a goal if Delaney gets a stick on it.
Daniluk from the goal line. Power move from Delaney out in front, but a great check from behind by D'Angelo to separate the man from the puck. Delaney takes it back out into the neutral zone in Delaware in a 3-3 contest after one with the Black Bears. A lot of different between fifth and second place right now. Centering pass out in front. Black Bears score. Retake the lead. Nikita Ivashkin capitalizes on the miscue from Trevor Martin and the Delaware defender, and Binghamton has the lead once again.
Yeah, an excellent job by Austin Thompson, getting aggressive on the forecheck, forcing that turnover and finding Nikita Ivashkin in front of the net with the wide open cage. Goal Black Bears, they take the lead 4-3, 17:15 left in the second period.
2:45 into the period, Black Bears grab the lead with the shortened bench. And now without Tyler Jurich, who's going to be the man to step up? Well, Ivashkin made a great play to put the Black Bears on top. Thompson made a great play to get the puck, passing it over to Ivashkin. Always like it to see guys make the extra pass. And now Gavin Yates is flying down the ice, man on a mission. Puck through the blue paint. Net comes off. Where's the puck? Green light comes on.
I think the official's going to say the net came off its cage before the puck went in the back of the net. I believe the puck is in the back of the net. However, got bumped off its mooring.
Good. And Brett Parker, who was part of the play first time this period. And Ivashkin cashes in. That is Nikita Ivashkin's 30th goal of the season. He's within the top 10 players in Binghamton history, Alex, across all 50 years. In all-time scoring.
And Nikita has been amazing so far this season with plays exactly like that, just putting himself in the right space at the right time.
Black Bears staying on the forecheck as Gavin Yates comes away with the loose puck, seeing Taylor Cutting take the spot of Tyler Jurich. That's big shoes to fill, but the Butcher's up to it. circling around with Yates. He's going to be a big body out in front. Double net front presence for the Black Bears right now. As Yates sears it down low for Parker, they try to work a cycle. Centering pass out in front, a little bit behind Parker, and the Thunder escape. Brendan O'Reilly crosses the line with Daniluk. They say not offsides. I think Delaware was thinking that the official was going to intervene there, as that puck is flipped high in the air like an infield fly. And now Gavin Yates will circle his own net. He's been out there for a long time, Alex. Trying to eye down Tyson Kirkby, maybe trying to connect on that stretch pass, but leaves it for Fitzgerald. This is the long second period change. So a little bit more for the Black Bears to get to the front of the bench. Kirkby out in front. Almost Ooh. Another own goal opportunity for Delaware right there as Wilson indirected it into the corner. Luckily, Martin was ready for it, saw it going wide. Yates cutting through the street. Penalty is coming up.
Oh, Brooks, that's a nasty hit on Yates. An accident, purely accidental. Yates gets taken down. Houston Wilson skating through the circle catches him up high with a knee. You hate to see that one, Brooks. That's a penalty going on Hannikainen. However, I think you're more concerned about Yatesy there, who gets up, goes to the bench. Just a complete accident by Houston. Nothing malicious there. Just a Wilson, sorry. Houston Wilson there. Just a...
So there's the... So for our friends on YouTube, the Heinz Ranger replay, Yates gets taken down by Hannikainen. That's the penalty. And then with Yates on the ice, Wilson's just left in a spot where he can't do anything. And
tries to get out of the way, but it's just one of those times where that contact's bound to happen.
So Yates now off the ice. He's on the bench. Second unit's out with Parker, Thompson, Ivoshkin, and Lopez. Schultz, the lone defenseman. Face-off one cleanly back to Lopez. Schultz tries to no-look pass that one back up to Lopez. Has it blocked. Thompson down low. Black Bears trying to extend their lead. They're 1-for-1 on the power play tonight. Lopez, top of the key, loads it up for Jake Schultz. Held in by the Texas native Chad Lopez. Schultz. Cross ice, Ivoshkin can't get there. Too hard on the pass from Weber. McVay coming out of his net to play it. He puts it right back out of the zone. And then from his 2 feet, blockers that one back out to the blue line. Shots on goal, 22.
Lots of oohs and ahs from the crowd there, Brooks.
You know, those are just more penalties from Hannikainen. Took a ton last night. Lopez, a slap shot save made by Martin. And cleared out of the zone. That's a one and done trip for the Black Bears. Just over the halfway point here of the penalty remaining. That's Schultz, a little bit lackadaisical getting off the ice. Black Bears almost got caught with too many men.
No, the thing is, Brooks, they only had four there with Schultz off. It was a smart play to hold off by the Black Bears players.
Oh, I thank you, Alex. Ivoshkin centers it out in front for Thompson off the toe of Martin. Steered away by Delaware's defense once again. McVay sets it up on a tee. Final third of this power play for the Black Bears. Fitzgerald and Oliveri, along with Lewis, Yates, and Kirkby. So they're electing to replace Durich with an extra defenseman here. Oliveri had a power play goal last night, looking to get another one here. Black Bears up by 1-4-3. Fitzgerald works it over into the faceoff dot for Yates. Cross size for Oliveri. Doesn't like the spacing that he has. Now creates some at the top of the umbrella. Fakes the shot. Right wing side off the top of the glove. Lewis gets to the rebound, and he scores. Mac Lewis with his fifth goal of the season. Black Bears up by 2 for the first time tonight.
And an excellent job by Mac Lewis recognizing the shot, flipping his body around, getting ready to clean up the garbage in front of that. Whiffs on his first attempt. Luckily on the second attempt, makes contact, puts it in the back of the net. 5-3 Black Bears, 13:56 in left in the second period.
6:04 time of the goal here. Black Bears have 2 in the first 6 minutes of the period.
I'll tell you what, Brooks. I don't know if this is the NHL or a level where they have a replay. I don't know if that goal stands. Tyson Kirkby got up into the mask of Martin on that one.
Delaney tries to go cross ice on the centering pass. McVay comes out of his net, swallows up a rebound. Delaware knocks it back out. Mac Lewis does get the goal. Don Oliveri getting the assist. Gavin Yates on the secondary helper as well. So we're back to 5-on-5, the way the game was designed to play. D'Angelo and Walters, this third defensive pairing, out on the ice right now. Chipped ahead by Walters. Ivoshkin tries to go off the boards for Thompson on a stretch pass, but it's intercepted by Asp. Apps left wing side on his forehand, centers up. McVay steers it back into the corner. Vinstrom, super low angle shot, throws it off the boards and bounces right onto the stick of Austin Thompson, putting it over for Ivoshkin. Ivoshkin, low to steam, now on the backhand, circles the net, didn't have the space for the wraparound, but does not get a shot off. Black Bears put it right back in the zone, but they're offsides. They're going to have to touch up. Schultz tries to one-hand that one into the zone. Not enough muscle on that one. Offsides for Delaware as the linesman signals a little bit late, but 26 shots now on goal for the Black Bears to Delaware's 23.
Yeah, Brooks, and I think Weber's a little happy almost that there is a offside in that because Kirkby was bearing down on him quickly.
Gavin Yates now with two assists on the night with that last helper. All that and more coming up as the Black Bears have a two-goal lead. They're up 5-3 here on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.
With our winner right behind me here.
Who?
Me? Yeah, you, buddy. What's your name?
Vincent.
Vincent, nice to meet you. How's school going?
Pretty good.
Welcome back to the action. Brooks Hill, Alex Jones here in a two-goal contest. The Black Bears scoring the first two goals of the period, Alex, thanks to Mac Lewis and Nikita Ivoshkin.
Yeah, and Brooks, they've also taken over the lead in shots, 26 for the Black Bears, 24 for the Delaware Thunder. This has been a high-octane thrill ride of a game so far. Penalties, goals, lots of opportunities on both ends of the ice. We'll see if the Black Bears can close this one out as we head into the second period.
It's a neutral zone faceoff coming up here. Black Bears will win the faceoff in the form of Josh Newberg over to Mac Lewis. Lewis getting his fifth goal of the season, but, you know, 13 assists on the year now as a shot's put off the inboards. Lively rebound off the plastic. Turnover, Kirkby down low, tried to shelf it again to the near side as he's pestered by Hannah Kynan. Black Bears are doing a good job on the forecheck, but get caught a little bit going after it. Wolf centers up.
Ooh, Brooks, what a play by Fitzgerald.
And here goes Mac Lewis trying to skate away. Lewis one-on-one, he's peppered by Daniluk. Good play by Daniluk to not take a penalty right there, as I don't think Martin saw that centering pass take a funny bounce off a stick out in front. Wolf is back-checked by Gavin Yates. Doesn't see that he had Brett Parker on the far side wall. Now gets behind his own net, and the breakout will commence. Here's the captain, Jake Schultz. Circling the net, cutting lost an edge down low. As he will seal his man down low. Puck just on the outside of the crease is cleaned up by Malushkin. And Rasmus Haas crossing the red line and blue line. Tries to split the defense, he does. Backhand and a toe save made by Riley McVay. Rebound still available. Delaware got to it. They threw a puck in from the blue line. McVay doing a good job to help maintain the insurance goal here in period number two. His best save of the contest.
Yeah, an excellent job by McVay, but as we say that, Delaware scores their fourth goal of the contest.
Black Bears could not get the puck out of the zone, and Dennis Gafferoff will cash in, and now it is a one-goal contest as Delaware ends the Binghamton scoring run at two.
Yeah, Gafferoff just put that right below the glove of Riley McVay, and you know Riley McVay wants that one back. McVay, one of the best goalkeepers in the Fed so far this season. Just a quick shot that gets right under the glove, goes in the back of the net. One-goal lead for the Black Bears, 5-4. 11-17, Brooks, left in the second period. Is this team that curse that we've been saying, that they let teams stick around and hang out and give up goals after big games, is that going to affect the Black Bears going forward?
Well, we'll see how they can respond. They're without one of their best players, Tyler Jurich, and they were able to score a couple of goals, but it'll be playing a defense will be the real difference maker in this one so far. Ivashkin running into a little bit of trouble as Delaware was going through a line change. Lopez going all the way across the ice for Austin Thompson. Thompson waiting up, drops it for Oliveri. Oliveri tries to shelf that one. That's another low angle shot. We saw Delaware take one a couple minutes ago. That goes off the glass. That will get deflected into the crowd. And it looks like a fan in the fourth row put a hand on that one. I think snagged it right away.
Yeah, Brooks, a great catch there. You know, as we tell all fans who come out to the games, make sure you have your eyes on the ice at all times. Pucks are one of those things that just constantly pop up into the stands in sport, in hockey specifically.
Josh Newberg puts the faceoff right in front of the Black Bears bench. Schultz will put it out into the neutral zone, chipped away by Kirkby. The SUNY Oswego Lakers, Kirkby and Lewis, will cause a four-man pileup temporarily on the half wall, but thrown back out into the neutral zone. Trevor Martin sets it up on a tee for Andre Ivanov. He put it right in the skates of Rasmus Aspen. Those are those turnovers in the Delaware end that's been costing the Thunder so far in this game, Alex.
Yeah, Brooks, a lot of turnovers in their own defensive end, which we've also seen from the Black Bears. Black Bears have a lot of time on ice, on puck, that they haven't been able to clear their own zone, which has been a long-term issue for the Black Bears this season.
Jacob Wolf and Tyson Kirkby getting together. Linesman coming to intervene. We got a media timeout. Black Bears up by one. They lead 5-4 here in this contest on Fox Sports 1430. Jesse's Gang, Gordon Construction, Security Mutual, Matthews Auto Group, Surf Pro, Brew Bituminous Products, Southern Tier Hockey Association, Binghamton Hockey Booster Club, Visions Federal Credit Union, and our season ticket holders. If you'd like to be recognized as a group, call 607-722-7367. Welcome back into Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton. We're exactly halfway through the contest. We already have 9 goals in this one as the Black Bears are up 5-4 with 9:54 left to go in the period.
Yeah, 53 shots to Brooks. That is a lot of shots through two periods. It's also gotten very physical. Tail end of the first period with the Jurich upper body injury. And then as we saw Volk and Kirkby going at it into that break, it'll be interesting to see if this continues throughout the entire contest. You can feel it building, Brooks. Let's see what's the spark that sets off the powder keg.
Faceoff is won back by the Black Bears. 5-on-5 hockey. Brett Parker steers it in down low for Yates on the backhand. And now held in by D'Angelo. Slap shot from Walters looking for a tip or maybe a set play going off the inboards. Black Bears do maintain control temporarily, but Rasmus Aspe will get to a loose puck, take a hit from Taylor Cutting down low, but Delaware exits the zone. On the stick of Deacon Stanza, now on his second team of the season. Aspe holds it in. His shot is in the skates of Taylor Cutting and sent down low. Wolf coming through the slot, running out of real estate, throws a shot that gets deflected into the safety netting and out of play.
And Brooks, this will end up in front of Riley McKay, I believe, to his left. One thing I have noticed here is that with that shortened bench, you get some mismatchings. Taylor Cutting is doing a good job on playing some forward in there with Gino D'Angelo playing some defenseman. Got a little bit of a switch swap on positions for those two.
Schultz takes the faceoff win back from Lopez and a stretch pass, no icing, tipped on the way through. Ivashkin's going to be the first man to it anyway. Running into his own man through the slot, chips it ahead for himself. Ivashkin, one-man show this offensive shift so far, and it'll turn over to Hannikainen. Hannikainen tries to put it off the stick of Wilson, but McVay will get to a loose puck and chip it ahead for Thompson. Black Bears do not clear. This has been the problem of the season so far. Centering pass out in front, and McVay makes a save on Gafarov that would have tied the game up. Backhand pass off the boards for Ivashkin, and they're going to say that Nikita was offsides at the blue line.
An interesting thing, Brooks, I'm not sure what Martin was trying to communicate. He was smashing his stick as Delaware turn their puck over. One trying to alert the defense. I didn't get to see it, but I think Mikita might have snuck out and was trying to grab one of those long stretch passes that he's been so good at getting those breakaways on and putting in the back of the net.
Well, you see goalies bang their stick on the ice when someone's coming out of the penalty box. They'll be like, hey, someone's behind you. And maybe the same thing's true there. Like, hey, Ivoshkin's behind the defense, so he slaps a stick on his ice so somebody will turn their head and look. Stretch pass off the boards this time to Austin Thompson, but he can't handle it cleanly. Right in front of the penalty box door, Delaware touches the puck, but Gafarov is offside as his feet were inside the offensive zone when he touched the puck.
Yeah, and an unfortunate one for Gafarov, too. He had a good opportunity there. Had a two-on-one opportunity that fizzled out.
Neutral zone faceoff one back by the Thunder. Hannah Connan will retreat after it. He's matched up for Coach Santini's club, but he turns it over. Ivoshkin couldn't handle it. A grade A opportunity. Ivoshkin would have been all alone searching for goal 31 of the season, second of the night, but instead, Delaware dodges a bullet. Chad Lopez, though, stays heavy on the forecheck. Oliveri coming in to lend a hand. Centering pass, nobody's home. Oliveri gets on the back check. Gafarov crosses the line, 3-on-3. Malushkin puts it too far ahead of Gafarov. Very low angle slap pass is fanned on. And now Schultz skating across the red line and blue, leaving it for Thompson. One touch passing over for Schultz, works it down low. Out in front for Newberg. Goalie made the first save, but Ivoshkin cashes in the rebound. There's goal number 31. There's his second of the night. And there's the two-goal lead back for Binghamton.
And when you get shots on net, that is going to happen, Brooks. Nikita Ivoshkin keeps his stick on the ice, off the goaltender's lag pad, ends right up in front of him. Easy goal for Nikita Ivoshkin for number 31.
Ivoshkin, the leading scorer on the team in goals and assists, 26 on the year, now 31 goals in the campaign. Newberg will take this face off. Go ahead, Alex.
I was just saying, Brooks, Ivanov there, you wish, if you're a Delaware fan, you wish he could have got the stick lift. It was right in front of him, and he just didn't realize the puck was right on Nikita Ivoshkin's stick.
Black Bears score, and let's take a listen to Frank Perney.
Nikita Ivoshkin. Assisted by number 14, Josh Newberg, and number 4, Jake Schultz. Time of the goal, 12:22.
So Ivoshkin, second of the night from Josh Newberg and Jake Schultz. Black Bears looking for more here as they have reclaimed their two-goal lead, 10 combined goals, just like last night. But we still have a lot of hockey left to go here in this one. O'Reilly crossing the line, tries to go between his legs. Backhand is denied by McVay. Rebound's unavailable. It falls onto the stick of Tyson Kirkby, leaving it for Yates. Yates crosses the line, toe drag between the legs, low angle. Martin makes the save. Rebound still available. Nifty move from Gavin Yates, but Trevor Martin stands tall in his crease.
Yeah, you almost wish Brooks Yates on that one would have just thrown the puck to the middle, hoping for a bad bounce that snuck into the back of the net.
A great move between the legs. I surely can't do that. That's why they pay Gavin the big bucks as they cross the line on sides. Yates waits up for Parker, tries to FIFA it to himself like a game of die on a Saturday afternoon. And now Yates sees the puck thrown out, and we're going to look and see what's going to happen.
I did not think that one caught the glass.
I don't think it caught anything. Everybody's getting together, cutting with a little bit of a shove on Hannah Kynan. Black Bears could be going on the power play, but penalty box door is still open. It looks like Hannah Kynan is going to get the gate for delay of game.
Yeah, Brooks being escorted by the linesman right now.
It's Yoda, he's right.
Yep, and it is Hannah Kynan who's going to the penalty box. The Black Bears will be on the power play. They have two power play goals tonight. They are 2-for-2.
And it looks like we're starting out with Parker, Thompson, Ivoshkin, Schultz, and Chad Lopez, a.k.a. the Pest from the Southwest.
12:53, the time of the penalty, delay game, puck over the glass. Take a look at the Heinz Energy replay. Hannah Kynan just throws it out of the zone into the first row. Centering pass right off the rip through the blue paint and out. Ivashkin now searching for the hat trick. He can do so on the power play. Delaware gets to a loose puck, and they chip it out of the zone. Jake Schultz will retreat and collect the loose change right outside his own faceoff dot. Thompson holding out at the blue line. Ivashkin, self-pass off the boards, gets to a loose puck, comes down the slot, holding on to it. Martin made the save, didn't see where the puck went. It's out in front of the net. Lopez at the top of the umbrella works it back over to the Russian Ivashkin. Schultz comes in, wrist shot, trying to go through the five hole. Martin makes the save, rebound is swallowed up by Delaware, but Lopez does a great job defensively to deny Delaware a shorthanded chance. Here comes Binghamton the other way. Schultz for Parker. Parker shot saved by Martin. And Wilson will just glide that puck down the ice. Tired bodies out for Delaware right now. They need to get some fresh legs out on the ice.
Yeah, Wolf chasing that down, Brooks. Could have gone for the change, but applied the pressure on the forecheck instead.
Rasmus Ask gets to a loose puck. Mac Lewis and Rasmus F were exchanging unpleasantries with each other last night, Alex. Don't know if you caught that at the end of the game, but neither one wanted to go. They couldn't drop the gloves. And now Black Bears cross the line. Stretch pass out in front. And Fitzgerald just poked it wide.
Yeah, Kirkby with the nutmeg there.
Gavin Yates down near the goal line, puts it on the tee for Mac Lewis. Oliveri centering pass for Kirkby. Martin made the save with his stick that time, covering up the five hole. Black Bears get to a loose puck. Colin Fitzgerald works it over for Gavin Yates. Yates switching spots with Fitzgerald through the slot. He's going to circle around, gets taken down. No call provided. Puck's going to come out, and Hannakainen is out of the penalty box. McVay is going to be forced to come out of his net to play the puck. He steers it on the backhand for Colin Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald takes a heavy hit with the referee looking right there. That one's by the book. And then Taylor Cutting comes in to lie a hit on Hannakainen. Penalty's coming up. Cutting had already dropped the gloves, and Hannakainen wanted no part of Taylor Cutting.
I think the butcher's reputation precedes him, Brooks.
Taylor Cutting sent over to the penalty box. Referees are going to discuss what's going to come of this one. And while they're doing that, we will take a step aside on Fox Sports 1430 in Binghamton.
Look up on the video boards. If it's you, you're the winner. And you get a great prize pack from Paul Battisti at Battisti Law Offices. Hey, keep cool by listening to Cool 106.7.
Black Bear fans, it's now time for the Rich Barber Company Clip of the Week. Now I lost it. One on one. Only time is up. Backhander stuff chance. He scores! Nikita Ivashkin, what a goal! He beats the goalie to the post. It's an even strength goal. It won't matter how you run it. Ivashkin second on the night.
Rich Barber Company located in the number 5 Commons at 41 South Washington Street, right here in downtown Binghamton. Give them a visit today.
Welcome back to the action here on Fox Sports 1430 in Binghamton. The Black Bears up by 2. They lead 6-4. But coming up, they're going to have to kill off 4 minutes of penalties as Taylor Cutting is sitting down in the box. I believe one for interference and then one for roughing is going to be sit.
Charging, Brooks.
Okay. Thank you, Alex. So we got Taylor Cutting in the box. Back-to-back. Essentially serving double minors. You said one for charging, and what was the other one, Alex?
I believe interference is the second one, Brooks. You know, Cutting coming into the zone did not like how Hannakainen there put Fitzgerald down, sticking up for his teammate. However, when you're up 6-4, that's not a penalty you want to take there. I understand looking out for your teammates, but that's a long, long power play for your shortened bench to deal with.
Yeah, puck's nowhere to be found right there. Interference makes sense. I don't understand the charging call right there. Or that puck's deflected. Referee right on top of it as soon as they start. Check that. Charging. Definitely can see that. And then unsportsmanlike conduct. Okay. So charging, I can see it. He's looking at him the whole way there. If the puck is there, that's a good hit.
Yeah, Brooks, it's just one of those where, you know what, he nothing to say about it, you know?
Yeah, Delaware, though, has two power play goals, so a lot of time to be man up right here. The Black Bears are going to have to dig in on the Northeastern Striping Corporation penalty kill. Rasmus Haps coming down low, puts it off the boards all the way back for Daniluk at the line, but Tyson Kirby right in his grill deflects the puck out into the neutral zone. Kirby with a hit for Deacon Stanza into the Delaware bench slightly. Newberg on the forecheck, trying to knock it down to himself, does a good job wasting some precious seconds off the clock. Just over 3 minutes left to go here in period number two. Black Bears up by two. Wilson will glide it in, and McVay does the smart thing and just holds on to it, and a faceoff coming up with 3:04.
Well, and Brooks, this is a little inside, you know, something you notice when you're at the game. Riley McVay gets the puck down, knows he's melting it down in his crease, however, waits until Houston is close enough to him to get on that puck. Houston Wilson charging in the net, but Riley McVay was able to kill a few extra seconds on the power play of the Delaware Thunder.
And if for our friends who are listening to Alex just saw that play, Oliveri acted like he was going to wrap it around the boards, so Houston Wilson vacated his spot to go ahead and seal on the half wall, and he just put it right out of the zone. Wilson had no idea where the puck was. Now Deacon Stanzo comes back into the zone cleanly, tries to center up for Ass. Loose puck is available, and the aforementioned Oliveri will push it down the ice 200 feet. Black Bears with that long second period change can only change the forwards as the puck is picked back up quickly by the Thunder. Malushkin throws a shot that's blocked by Walters. Oliveri had it hop his stick. Walters sends a man down to the ice. That'll get the crowd a little excited. Back up to the point, though, for Ivanov. Ivanov leaves it for Malushkin. Down low, they cut towards the middle. Great stick by JT Walters to deny the centering pass. Black Bears get to a loose puck, throw it down the length of the ice once again. And now it looks like Walters is going to be able to get off for a line change. Here comes Jake Schultz to take a spot.
Yeah, it's Melso that got him, caught him in the corner there. Just an awkward hit on Walters.
Tyson Kirby with a steal, short-handed. Black Bears a little bit out of gas. Oliveri needs to get a line change. He's singling to the bench. He's going to join the play and probably skate off on the way back to the bench. D'Angelo has half his body on the ice ready to go to take his spot. Lopez coming off for Newberg back out there for the second time shorthanded. Black Bears have killed off the first minor to Taylor Cutting. Now they have to kill off the second one. 90 seconds left to go in the Northeastern Striping Corporation penalty kill. Gafarov has it in his skates, back up for Ivanov, a slap shot, nobody out in front. McVay saw that one all the way. Newberg backhands it out of the zone, and Martin's going to have to come out to play the puck. Oliveri has not gotten off the ice yet, Alex, since we started this penalty kill. Long shift for 13 dressed in black. Malushkin dancing in the faceoff dot, tries to get it over for Gafarov. Schultz and Gafarov get acquainted with each other down low in the corner. Here comes round two. Schultz wisely pulls off the trigger that time, and Ivashkin will skate away one-on-one. Josh Newberg will try to skate away, but Weber's back defensively. Two-on-two, now two-on-one. Ivashkin looking for the hat trick. Power move denied by Martin, and he will play the puck himself, throws it right back out. 30 seconds left to go with the penalty.
That was a silly play by Martin.
Maybe he thought that one of his guys was going to be there. Instead, Binghamton had the puck temporarily. Now Delaware comes the other way. Weber tries to drag it around Thompson. 15 seconds left to go in the period. Schultz gets it to his forehand, puts it down the length of the ice. Ivashkin was chasing after it, and he's going to chase the goaltender. 5 seconds left to go here in this one. Final push for the Thunder. But instead, Daniluk will retreat into his own end. And that is where we will stand after two periods of play. Black Bears, 6. Delaware, 4.
Yeah, 11 seconds left in the Taylor Cutting double minor. You know, a great job by the Black Bears killing off that penalty, and just an excellent job limiting the opportunities that Delaware had on a long, long power play.
Black Bears are skating off, and the Worldwide Sports Supply Ice Crew is making their way for a fresh sheet of ice. Our ringside reporter, Cole Parenti, is now standing by with Mac Lewis. Take it away, Cole.
From Alex Mack, you scored a big goal in that period. Can you walk me through that goal from your perspective?
Yeah, it was just a power play goal. You know, get to the front of the net and crash the net and make sure there's a screen and bury the puck. So.
Mack, you're up by two now, but you know Delaware is going to be prepared to come out in the third to try to come away with this one. How do you guys weather the storm and make sure you come away with a win?
We just got to keep playing our game, you know, keep it simple. We're short benched right now. Lost a couple guys during the game, so we just got to keep it simple and play our game, and I think we'll come out on top.
Thanks, Mack. Good luck the rest of the way. Brooks, Alex, I'm throwing it back up to you guys in the booth.
Thank you, Cole. Excellent job as always, and we're going to take a quick timeout, come back with the Excite Motorsports intermission report for the second period break after these messages on Fox Sports 1430 in Binghamton.
Black Bears will take on the Danbury Hattricks on Friday, February 17th at 7 p.m. We invite everyone to stay for a post-game skate, so bring your skates to the arena and get your tickets now at BinghamtonBlackBears.com. We can't wait to see you out there on the ice. Black Bear fans, it's now time for the Bricks Barber Company Clip of the Week.
And now Ivoskin one-on-one. Penalty time is up. Backhander stuff chance. He scores! Nikita Ivoskin, what a goal! He beats the goalie to the post. It's an even strength goal. It won't matter how you ride it. Ivoskin, second of the night.
Bricks Barber Company, located in the number 5.
Don't settle for less. Ask for American Standard Heating and Air Conditioning. American Standard, built to a higher standard.
If you're looking to install a beautiful, durable, and handcrafted countertop, call Ellis James Construction. The Southern Tier's most trusted stone fabrication will design and install your dream countertop and let you choose from a premium selection of natural stones like marble, granite, or quartzite. Stone or granite countertops starting as low as $35 per square foot installed. Schedule your free quote and receive a free sink with your countertop project. Call 607-275-5495.
Think of good things.
Good day.
Like calming tempers down.
Good day.
And passing them around.
So stand up and cheer. We're back to the beer.
Good day.
Share a good-natured Canadian Pilsner.
Are you looking for a new place to live? Lofts at JC is the official housing partner of the Binghamton Black Bears and the only luxury housing provider offering both 2 and 3 bedroom units. fully furnished for a modern living lifestyle. Lofts at JC is centrally located in the heart of the Tri-Cities area, located at 128 Grand Avenue in Johnson City. Housing applications are accepted online at loftsatjc.com. Once again, that's loftsatjc.com.
Magic 101.7.
Best radio station.
Keeps getting better.
Better music selection.
Best ever. Makes me feel better.
Number one for music and fun.
It's like the best ever.
Magic 101.7. 100% local.
A wreck is a wreck. An arrest is an arrest. Alcohol, cough syrup, painkillers, sleeping pills. It doesn't matter. Impaired is impaired. And it will be prosecuted. Going out tonight? Your local police will be out too. Don't drive. Get a ride. Brought to you by your New York State Stop DWI program.
The Black Bears return to the ice on February 17th to take on their rival, the Danbury Hat Tricks. American Special Hockey Association will be in attendance and tabling around the concourse, so make sure to stop by their tables and enter in some of their raffle items, and you can find out more information about the American Special Hockey Association on their website, specialhockey.org.
Into the slot, and Kirby scores on the one-timer.
You do not want to miss 1 minute of Binghamton Black Bear action this upcoming season. With individual game tickets as low as $10 and outstanding group rates, there is no reason to wait to get your tickets to book your group. Call 607-722-7367 or check us out online at BinghamtonBlackBears.com. Fans, the Binghamton Black Bears are partnering with the Broome Tioga Workforce of New York for the 23rd Annual Career Fair. It'll be Friday, February 17th between 2:30 and 5:30 p.m. right here inside Vision Veterans Memorial Arena. Bring your resume to the career fair and receive a free ticket to the Black Bears game that evening. We can't wait to see you on February 17th.
Welcome back to the third period, brought to you by our friends at American Standard Heating and Cooling. They are built to a higher standard. We got Alex's keys to the game a couple of minutes ago on the other side of that TV timeout. Black Bears still have to kill off 11 seconds to the Taylor Cutting double minor.
Yeah, Brooks, and it's going to take a little bit of, it's going to be a little bit of an easier kill for the Black Bears to get the puck from neutral ice, center ice, into the offensive zone. Normally takes about 5-6 seconds. So really, if Delaware wins this and everything goes perfectly for them, they're going to have one chance at a shot before the penalty ends.
Cutting makes his way back over to the penalty box. Newberg will take this faceoff. One faceoff win ought to do it for penalty time. Cutting sits down for a little bit longer break. He'll get right back up in just a couple of seconds. Referees all look at each other, confer, and we are underway, ready to go. Delaware on the final stretch of their power play. 3 seconds left to go. Weber drops it back for Deacon Stanza. That puck pops up high, but behind the net of McVay. Cutting rejoins the play. Can't get off on a clean line change, and a wrist shot is put wide of the target. Cutting's going to go after Ivanov, but instead get off to the bench, and Nikita Ivashkin will come on and take his spot. We're back to 5-on-5.
Yeah, Brooks, right now Delaware has the puck deep in their own zone. Kirkby is pushing it. Stolen, and right in front of the net, Kirkby, puck on a stick. Rebounds bouncing around out front, and Delaware ends up with it.
Black Bears trying to get another goal here in period number three. They got a quick one last night in period number two, just 25 seconds in. And tonight they got one 2:15 into the middle frame as well. Thompson tries to stretch a pass out to Ivashkin but can't connect on it. He touches up, he's onside. Schultz on that fresh ice, that puck is gliding off the sticks of both sides. Centering pass out in front, Lopez slaps one. It gets deflected by Malushkin out in front and out of play.
Yeah, Lopez really looked like he liked that shot. Disappointed that Malushkin was able to stick with him. He thought he was going to get a easy shot at net there in a prime real estate location.
Lopez, Thompson, and Ivashkin with D'Angelo and Walters. D'Angelo passes the puck over into the faceoff dot for Thompson. Throws it right into the chest of the goaltender, who makes an easy. Delaware can't keep control of the puck. However, they do clear. And the Black Bears are forced to touch up at the line. No icing, says the linesman at the head of the play. And now Ash tries to backhand one out of the zone. He will successfully. But same story. Delaware clears the puck, doesn't get control. And the Black Bears will take it behind their own net and start the breakout. Lopez now skating with it across the red line. Tries to go through Daniluk, but it is denied. Malushkin camped out the other side. Goes one-on-one with D'Angelo. Finds Gaffer off the open man. Throws a wrist shot. McVay, I believe, got a piece of that one as that was stinging underneath the bar. But McVay stands tall. Here come the Black Bears the other way. Ivashkin and Thompson. Thompson shot high off the glass. Held in, though, by Schultz. Schultz through the slot. Throws his wrist shot. Save made by Martin once again. Delaware didn't know who wanted to play the puck off the rebound. It'll be Daniluk coming through the right wing side. Throws it off the shoulder of McVay. He wore that one kind of hard like we talked about in the first intermission interview, and here he reached down and melt that one.
Yeah, and Riley McVay is a very active goalkeeper for the Black Bears. Likes to really get out there and greet the shot. Uses his shoulders a lot, being a little bit of a shorter guy to extend his save radius, and an excellent job knocking that one down as the Black Bears win the draw. But a quick shot from Delaware.
Yeah, McVay had to paddle that one away. Thank you for covering that one, Alex, while I took a sip of water. And now Mac Lewis chasing after it. He might beat out the icing, and in fact he does. Great hustle from Mac Lewis. Tried to center up, blindly throwing a puck to the net. Not a bad idea, but it doesn't work out that time for the Black Bears.
Yeah, Gavin Yates, I think Mac Lewis expected Gavin Yates to be driving the net. However, Yates went to pinch the boards.
And he drives the net again right there, puts that shot wide of the target. Rasmus Aft centers it up in front of his own net, and that was a dangerous play from Delaware, throwing a blind pass into the slot while the Black Bears were still on the offensive side. Centering attempt up for Delaney is denied by McVay. Right onto the stick of Brett Parker. Waits for Gavin Yates to get down low with him. 2-on-2 as they work the big little game down low. Oliveri trying to put on a little razzle-dazzle across the inboards, but it will be intercepted by the Delaware Thunder, and Asp comes the other way. That puck is chipped back out into the neutral zone. Yates paws it down legally to himself. knows that he has some tired defensemen, and he does the wise thing, get behind his own net and leave it for Colin Fitzgerald. Shots on goal, 41, Binghamton, 32 for Delaware. Taylor Cutting enters the zone. He's on sides. He's playing on this line with Josh Newberg and Tyson Kirkby. Fitzgerald calling for the pass, looking for a tip from Kirkby. Didn't get one in the right spot and shoved back out into the neutral zone by the Thunder.
Tell you what, Brooks, Cutting came into the zone with some speed there, really cooking.
Cutting him out to play the puck again, steers it on the backhand for Kirkby. Kirkby looking over to the bench, signaling that if he gets the chance, he's ready to get off. Ivoshkin line out on the ice, partially. Right now, Newberg and Kirkby at the end of their shifts. Got two Black Bears chasing the same guy right there, and now Newberg's going to come off the ice, and Chad Lopez is going to come on to take his spot. Turnover, though. Austin Thompson gets it. Nifty move from Lopez. Ivoshkin was waiting on it. And Toivo Heinikainen comes the other way with it. Through the slot, shot wide of the net. Off the inboards, follow up his own rebound, just like a basketball point guard. And now Wolf, 16 in white, dancing around one defender. Tries to throw a wrist shot towards the net, but Ivoshkin passes it off the boards to himself. Now Thompson, right wing side, tried to drop it back for Ivoshkin, but off the skates of Malushkin. Here comes Delaware the other way. Aft, back to Wilson. Tries to get around Fitzgerald. Centering pass out in front. Excellent back check by Chad Lopez to take away the stick of Malushkin. Thompson leaves it for Lopez, plays onside. Lopez, power move, wraparound denied by Martin. Ivoshkin trying to get it on his backhand on the stuff chance opportunity. Hops his stick at the last second. Black Bears go off for a line change.
Yeah, Chad Lopez with a very strong offensive opportunity there as Gavin Yates gives up the puck and gives up a breakaway. And we got a goal, Brooks.
Got a goal. Gavin Yates turned the puck over. And before the net came off its pegs, the referee signaled goal. And this is like almost identical to the situation that we had in Danbury a couple of weeks ago, Alex, on the road where the net gets dislodged incidentally by a defending player and the puck is in between where the goalposts stand back at the inboards.
And Brooks, I think either way, this one's going to be, looks like he got in actually before the net came off its mooring. And also either way, Brooks, I think even if that puck doesn't go in the back of the net, that's gonna be a penalty shot for the Delaware Thunder as Yates wins the draw and pulls the puck along the red line, passes it to himself in the offensive zone.
Yep, now Yates is mad that he just gave up a goal, so he's gonna go back out there and try to get it right back. Fitzgerald wraps it in around the boards, and Taylor Cutting down low in the corner by himself temporarily. Tried to fumble with it a little bit, but unfortunately, hops the stick. Parker, turnaround shot in the slot, gets his rebound. Second shot is swallowed up by Martin, and we're back to a one-goal game with 14:09 left to go.
Yeah, the hit off Ivanov's leg popped right back to Parker. However, Martin tracked it the whole way.
Delaware has the only goal of the period so far. It belongs to TJ Delaney, and we have a one-goal game. 14:09 left to go in this one. You're listening to Fox Sports 1430.
Binghamton fans, what time is it?
It's T-shirt time.
Chuck-a-puck? If so, scan the QR code on the screen for a second chance to be entered to win the CF Moto ATV from Excite Motorsports.
Welcome back to the action here on Fox Sports 1430. Binghamton, Delaware has scored the only goal of the period so far through the first 5 minutes and 51 seconds. Black Bears trying to regain an insurance goal here with an offensive zone faceoff.
Yeah, Brooks, and Newberg, Lewis, and Kirkby out there for the forwards. Fitzgerald and Walters, looks like coach has done a little reshuffling with the injuries to the defensive pairs.
Delaware wins the faceoff, held in, though, by Fitzgerald. The lefty throws it in off the boards, looking for a good bounce. Centering attempt from Kirkby is denied before it ever started. He just has to play it back down low for Lewis. Lewis for Newberg out in front. Kirkby's going to find it on his stick. Gets separated by Hannah Kynan. And Rasmus Afs comes away with the puck. It's been a good hockey game tonight, Alex, no matter what team you're pulling for. Delaware jumped out to a 2-0 lead. Then Binghamton scored the next three in the final 30 seconds of the period. Delaware was able to tie the game up as that puck gets deflected out of play. Black Bears build a lead, 5-3, then 5-4, then 6-4, and now we're back to 6-5.
And they always say, you know, popular turn of phrase, most dangerous lead in hockey is a two-goal lead. We'll see how it turns out for the Black Bears as Thompson, Lopez, and Ivashkin are out there on forward.
Lopez tries to win it forward to himself, get onto the stick of Ivashkin, but instead hops over to Austin Weber. Now, here come the Thunder the other way. Shot absorbed by McVay. Rebounds available. 3-on-2 for the Black Bears. All the forwards going up against the Delaware defenseman. Lopez back over to Thompson. Backhand in the splits. Ooh. Martin makes the save. Ivashkin and Thompson run into each other. Lopez stuffed chance denied by Martin. Tries to get to the rebound, but Jacob Wolf will get there first instead. And now Austin Weber tries to skate around Don Oliveri and will find the stick of Jake Schultz, and Delaware is forced to touch up on the delayed offsides. Rocca DiConstanza, the former member of the Watertown Wolves, has seen plenty of the Black Bears this year with coming over from Watertown. We won't see Watertown for any other time during the regular season. And now another time, stretch pass on the stick of Malushkin in alone. McVay makes a breakaway save. That's your NY529 college savings save of the game right there. Mark it down. 12:30 left to go in the game. On the breakaway, Riley McVay stands tall. Going the other way. Penalties coming up. Late call from the official if this is on Binghamton.
I didn't see that one, Brooks. I was watching the back of the play. It's going to be on Oliveri. You see a Thunder player go down to the ice. They hit their wrist down. And then they're calling, I'm going to assume, either a slash or some sort of contact there, which I was watching that area, but I did not see happen. Maybe we can get that on the Heinz Energy replay, Brooks, because I don't know if that one, that might be a guilt by geographic location.
It looked like it was a little bit of a late call from my vantage point, because initially the referee had signaled Olivieri played the puck off his hand and then touched it with his own stick, so it nullifies a hand pass. That was the first thing, and then the puck gets around the boards. Take a look at the Heinz injury replay. So he gets back up, and yeah, that's a two-handed baseball swing right there, and the referee did finally see it, and that's the right call. And again, I think that's the retaliation that the referee might have missed the first thing, that which put Olivieri on the ground, which forced him to get back up on his feet.
Yeah, and Brooks, whatever happened, Olivieri was not happy in the slightest. Went into the box very heated.
Yeah, so here comes Olivieri. He thinks he probably got taken down by a trip as the Black Bears win the faceoff and throw it out to neutral ice.
Well, Brooks, players get very sensitive when you get into the legs like that. That's where a lot of injuries do occur.
Kirkby throws a shove at Wilson, and that puck will be slapped into the safety netting. Now, Schultz is in front of the blue line, so that can't be delay a game.
And it's going to be center ice, Brooks.
Okay. All right. No side gets an advantage there. I thought it was tipped. Either way, I thought it was tipped by somebody. So we're going to...
Well, when you get that flutter, like you said earlier, Brooks, and that's what happened to that puck. It fluttered up and hit the rafters, maybe the net. I'm not 100% sure.
Dimitri Danilug with it on his forehand, passing it over to Houston Wilson, trying to tie this game up at 6. Malushkin, top of the point for Danilug. Down low into the left wing side. Centering pass for DiConstanza. Goes off McVay. Fitzgerald gets to a rebound behind the net. Delaware, though, still with control of the puck. Back up to the top of the point. Danilug, wrist shot. Paddle down by McVay on the blocker save. Might have caught DiConstanza out in front, but it sounded like a blocker. Danilug again, down low, intercepted by Schultz. Sends Wilson into the boards. Puts it off the kick plate. Black Bears will get a much needed line change.
Yeah, it's going to be a fire sale change for the Black Bears. All four penalty killers coming off the ice.
44 shots on goal for the Black Bears, 36 for the visiting Delaware Thunder. Delaware playing their best game of the season against the Black Bears, arguably right here. One goal contest, and the Thunder are on the power play. Ivanov back over to Malushkin. Through the faceoff dot, wrist shot is absorbed by D'Angelo. And Ivanov gets it right back up. Slap shot, that time hits JT Walters out in front, blocks a shot to make the play, and throws it down the length of the ice as well.
And Kirkby got caught with somebody sticking their skate out on him. He was slow going back to the bench.
Ollie Venstrom crossing the line, centers up. Back out in front, Venstrom had a wide open net, and he fanned on the puck. Black Bears get it out. Where do they say this is going? This is back in the defensive zone, but I believe they say it was tipped.
Yeah, Brooks, 100% went off the glass.
Let's take a look at this Heinz injury replay. Look how open this net is for Ollie Venstrom for his second of the night. Nobody home.
No, Gino D'Angelo makes a mistake, but comes backward, getting his stick on the stick of...
Tyson Kirkby skating over to the locker room door, running back into the locker room, holding his helmet. Hopefully that's just an equipment issue. Head equipment trainer Dylan Konecki, I believe, is meeting him over there, took the back route. Crowd getting into this one. And now Chad Lopez on his forehand. Centers up, low angle. Martin denies that opportunity for the Thunder. 10 minutes left to go here in the period. Black Bears have killed off the penalty. We return to 5-on-5. Here comes Ivoshkin, 1-on-2. Gets in between the two Delaware defenders. Loses control of the puck temporarily, but keeps it on his stick. A wrist shot and absorbed by Martin.
An excellent snag there by Martin to not give up a rebound as Ivoshkin drove the net.
We're going down the stretch in a one-goal game between the Delaware Thunder and the Binghamton Black Bears. Black Bears up 6-5 after these messages on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton. .45 left to go here in the third period. Black Bears and Thunder are in a one-goal contest, 6-5. Good night if you took the over. Unfortunately, nobody offering odds on FPHL hockey. We want to thank our friends at Tioga Downs Casino Resort for being a proud sponsor of the Black Bears once again. They have a lovely Zamboni wrap that we get to see every home game. And they have provided all of our season ticket holders with vouchers for free buffet all the way back at the beginning of the season. So make sure to check your season ticket holder gift bag. You got a free buffet at Tioga Downs.
Yes, as the Black Bears lose the draw in the offensive zone.
Puck is going to be thrown down the length of the ice. This is icing. Goes off the side of the net and not McVay. No contest put up from Delaware. From our vantage point, I thought McVay had to play it. But instead, this will come all the way back into the Delaware zone. And the Black Bears have an offensive zone faceoff.
Yeah, a smart play by McVay, making sure to hold the post just in case it does get down there, but skips just inches wide.
Puck gets chipped off the high glass, and now Thompson and Lopez fight for it. Thompson on his forehand, centers up for Ivoshkin, but he gets denied. Thompson, very low angle, gets deflected into the safety netting and out of play.
Yeah, that's going to be in the BAE and Systems and Guthrie faceoff circle. The left of goalkeeper Martin. 9:24 Brooks left in this third period. Black Bears have to keep pushing the offensive opportunities, put one in the back of the net to give themselves that insurance goal.
Delaware will win the faceoff and finds the stick of Danilo Malushkin. He drops it back for Gafarov, and those two will play catch. Malushkin, saucer pass out in front, and McVay knocks the net off its pegs. Haven't seen that a ton. That must have not been put all the way back down from when Gavin Yates and Riley McVay collided a little bit earlier this period.
It could have also happened, Brooks, on that as McVay slams the door shut on the icing, he could have accidentally dislodged it ever so slightly. Right now, the linesman is working on it, getting it back onto its mooring.
Looks like they get the net back on its pegs, and we're ready to go. Wilson and Lopez face off with each other, and a great job by Chad Lopez tying up Wilson, allowing Austin Taunton to come in and win the faceoff. Black Bears will go behind their own net as they try to clear the zone, but Delaware's offsides, and they did not get back.
Yeah, and Schultz laid a big, big hit on Rasmus Ask right in front of the Black Bears bench.
Neutral zone faceoff in front of the Black Bears bench. But Tyler Jurich has not returned to this contest. We will try to provide an update soon as possible. Schultz almost turned it over to TJ Delaney, but the Black Bears get back defensively, get it out in front of their net, and now it finds a stick of Brett Parker. Black Bears dressed in the first time for Star Wars night here with our friends over at Disney and Lucasfilm, providing some design inspiration for Bobby Gross, who did an excellent job designing these jerseys. Parker works it back over to Colin Fitzgerald, looking for a tip. Gets a late one from Gavin Yates, really took a lot of speed off of that shot. Puck is going to be thrown out back into the Black Bears end. Oliveri touches up along with Gavin Yates. Saucer out in front for Parker. Martin makes the save. I don't think Martin thought he did the way that he reacted to it. And Daniluk will now cross the line going the other way. Throws a shot, and McVay will just shoot that one into the safety netting and out of play.
Yeah, Brooks, I'd love to see that one on the Heinz injury replay. It looks like it might have snuck in for half a second, but I think Martin's the one who shuts the door here.
Yeah, he shuts the door. He sticks up in the air. Normally when a goalie is in that full butterfly like that, you see the pads together or the stick out in front to cover up any space that he can. The way that he turned his head makes you think that maybe he didn't know where it was. Best thing to do if you don't know where it is to stay still as a goal. You don't want to knock it in your own net. Stretch pass is going to force Trevor Martin to come out of his net and dive on top of it.
And Brooks, because that's a multi-line clear killing in your own zone, even if Delaware wanted to, they could not change. I'm correct?
Yes, that
unlike,
is.
Unlike, though, the icing penalty, you cannot choose the circle of it.
Josh Newberg, Taylor Cutting, and Austin Thompson, the forwards. And Josh Newberg's going to be kicked out. And Thompson's going to come in and replace. So a little bit of a line shuffle here for the Black Bears. Cutting, Thompson, and Newberg, the forwards.
Oh, big hit by Taylor Cutting.
Yeah, Rasmus Ask gets back up to his feet after he collected his stick. No arms up in the air, so we play on at 5-on-5. Wrapped all the way around, McVay comes out to slow it down. Weber throws it to the net instead, and McVay catches it from behind the goal line, melts it down. A little bit of an extra whistle to maybe stop Taylor Cutting in his tracks.
Actually, Brooks, it was the opposite. Weber came in and gave him a little extra shove at the end of that play.
Everybody changing for the Thunder, and the forwards getting off for the Black Bears. 7:41 left to go here in a one-goal contest. Face-off won by the Black Bears. They had a set play, but Schultz didn't get everything he wanted on that clearing attempt. Fitzgerald will find Lopez stretched out at the midline. Now coming in, power move out in front. Chad Lopez, oh my gosh. The Pez from the Southwest absolutely undresses the goaltender, and the Black Bears reclaim a two-goal lead.
Yeah, Chad Lopez with it, a phenomenal feat. Goes forehand, backhand, forehand, and skies the water bottle of Martin, sending the Black Bears on a 7-5 lead. Excellent stretch pass as the Black Bears noticed that Delaware had committed a defender up into the attacking zone and only had Hennekainen back, and you can't leave a big guy like Hennekainen against a fast player like Chad Lopez. Maybe one of the fastest players in the Fed.
Ivashka now with the puck behind the goal line. Black Bears are up to 7. Now they got to 8 last night. Colin Fitzgerald picks up his second assist of the night. And Ivashin gets his first assist of the night as well. Wolf puts it down low into the corner. Fitzgerald muscles off his man. And now, perhaps the littlest guy on the ice for the Black Bears, Fitzgerald, steaming ahead into the offensive zone, trying to join the rush. Black Bears, two men on the forecheck. Lopez takes a little bit of a Falcon punch right there on the forecheck. Ivashkin gets tied up with Deacon Stanzo. I think they got their skates twisted up.
Yeah, Deacon Stanzo kind of stuck his rear out there to get into the path of Ivashkin.
Ivashkin with 2 goals and assists now, a 3-point night. He's going to get off for a line change. And Austin Thompson's going to come and take his spot. Eric Molesso crossing all 3 lines by himself. Throws a backhand way wide of the target. Looks like Tyson Kirkby's back at the locker room door. And now he has to go back in the locker room one more time. Don't know what happened with Tyson Kirkby, but he's missed the last couple of minutes. Maybe that's why we're seeing some of the lines jumble up. So Hughes is going to try to rejoin the team at the next whistle. Gavin Yates passes it up over to Brett Parker. Elevated pass onside. Thompson tries to get around his man. Cannot. Gets on the forecheck, though. Second chance. Leaves the puck out in front in the left side of the slot. On the far side of your screen back at home, JT Walters now gets to a loose puck. And now Yates one hand touches it up. Kirkby with his helmet back up on his head at the door, ready to rejoin the team at the next whistle. Cutting on the forecheck. Can't get the puck away from Rasmus Asp. Has a stick out on the ice. A stretch pass is unattainable for Dennis Gafaroff. Thrown down the length of the ice. And this is icing against the Black Bears. And Tyson Kirkby comes back out and rejoins his team.
And Brooks, Kirkby being back out on the ice is huge for the Black Bears. They were down to 8 total forwards. As well. I mean, you can mix Gino D'Angelo in there, who I learned earlier this week started out his hockey career playing defense. That's why we've seen so much of him back there. It's his first position.
5:20 left to go here. Lewis. Oh, no, excuse me. That was Newberg taking the faceoff with Wilson. Wilson gets the better. A wrist shot looking for a tip from Houston Wilson out in front is unattainable, and Oliveri will get the puck behind his own net. Throw it right out in front. Finds Taylor Cutting. I don't think that pass was intended for him, but it'll work out either way for the Black Bears as the Butcher gets the puck down low. Ivanov. A one-touch passing over to Malushkin. Now Malushkin tries to go around Oliveri, and that's going to be a hard push. Jake Schultz wants to join the rush, takes a friendly bounce off the boards. And Schultz comes in, low to speed for the big guy, but at the last second, it's stripped away by Toivo Heinikainen. Ivashkin centers up, skate to stick. Tyson Kirkby gets pushed down to the ice in the crease. And
Rasmus Asp is not going to be making any friends on the Black Bears for that one, Brooks.
No, they're not. We're going down the stretch here. 4:33 left to go in this one. You're listening to Black Bears Hockey on Fox Sports 1430.
Valentine's
center up. And now Jake Schultz throws it back over to Houston Wilson. And now Rasmus Asp. Stretch pass for Gavroff is intercepted by Oliveri. Puts on a spin cycle, but a two-on-one will develop the other way with Gavroff and Wilson. Schultz does a good job and steers the puck away. Now Ivashkin, can he get there? Out in front, looking for the hat trick, just wide.
Yeah, Brooks, looks like Ivashkin was looking for the five-hole goal there. Martin did not bite.
3:30 left to go here. DeConstanzo crossing over the line. He gets it knocked away by the Black Bears, who now have a two-goal lead, up by two. A shot from the point, deep on the point, rather, from the red line, is held on by Riley McVay. Offensive zone faceoff coming up for the Thunder, and Martin is still in his net.
Yeah, Brooks, 3:20 left. You'd have to expect, once we get right around 2 minutes, he's going to be called to the bench for the extra attacker.
Faceoff won back by the Thunder, and Weber has it on his stick. Weber with a primary assist in tonight's contest. Wrist shot through the slot, and he scores. Austin Weber makes it a one-goal game. 3:10 left to go.
That's the problem, Brooks, with these mismatched lines for the Black Bears. A complete defensive breakdown between who's got who in the switch leads to Weber just walking basically in and getting a free shot in some expensive real estate in the defensive zone for the Black Bears.
One goal contest once again. Delaware Thunder fans who made the trip, making their presence known with their cowbells. And now the puck is going to be put on the stick of JT Walters. And we have a 7-6 shootout style game here tonight. What a play by Lewis Newberg's shot is denied. Lewis does the smart thing, just rejoins the play, not going to argue with the official about anything. Newberg works it down low, and now this is the line that we saw start the game. Kirkby, Lewis, and Newberg out on the ice. Back up to the point. They work it down back, down low for Lewis. Lewis tried to turn around to his forehand, but it's going to get intercepted. This is going to be icing against Delaware if the Black Bears get there, and they do with 2:30 left to go.
Yeah, and Brooks, Mac Lewis really, really has that can't stop, won't stop mentality. Has him staying with the puck when no one else did on both sides. Drives the net and gets a good shot at an offensive opportunity. Not able to get the back of the net.
Crowd trying to get back into this one. They know that the Black Bears are oh so close to the finish. Oliveri at the red line. Throws the puck, and that one's going to get deflected into section 28. I think that's row CC.
Yep, literally hit directly underneath CC13. Split the fans right down the middle.
So that last goal is Austin Weber, Justin Movali getting the assist for Delaware. Neutral zone faceoff right in front of the penalty box. Faceoff won back by the Black Bears. And now they just dump it in. Trevor Martin steers it out, keeps the clock running. Black Bears 48 shots on goal. They've gotten to 50 one time this year, Alex. Oliveri goes for the hit. Wilson now coming down through the slot, chips it ahead into the corner. McVay reached out for it, but it was taken away by Lopez, I believe. Held in by Ivanov. Oliveri blocks a shot, and now Ivashkin should be able to get the puck out of the zone. He circles back instead. And it'll find the stick of Brett Parker. Parker gets the red line. Step one and gets the puck deep. Parker's looking for a call. And I believe Gafferoff is too. Turnaround shot way wide of the target. 90 seconds left to go here in this one. One goal game. Delaware signaling over to the bench. They're ready to pull the goaltender. Stretch pass is deflected. McVay sets it up on a tee and steers it over for Oliveri. Oliveri. Over to Lewis. Lewis gets it deep again. That'll force Trevor Martin to stay put.
A great job too, Mac Lewis, holding this puck deep in, not allowing Delaware to get possession to try to clear it.
Black Bears have Schultz and Oliveri back deep already. Newberg was already playing as the high forward in a one-goal game. Martin creeping his way over to the bench. McVay steers it up. Schultz sends a man down to the ice. Martin halfway between the bench and the goal. 50 seconds still to go here in this one. And there goes Trevor Martin as soon as the puck is thrown out. Martin coming back. Might have got a piece of it. And they have icing as the call, but I believe Martin touched the puck. So this could be a neutral zone faceoff coming up.
Yeah, Brooks, it's going to be an interesting call because Martin also made an effort to play it. He went after the puck and had a chance to stop that puck. So it'll be interesting to see what the call is. Timeout for the Delaware Thunder. Yeah, interesting call there, Brooks, because it looks like they were sticking with the icing call. Therefore, this will give the Black Bears a little bit of rest. Yes, they can't change, but there were some tired Black Bear defenders out on the ice, which is a huge advantage for the Black Bears now, being able to get that rest. If you're Delaware, you do want the advantage of setting up your set play with the keeper pole, but you're also giving Black Bears 60 seconds to get that oxygen back in their system.
That's the voice of Alex Jones. 43 and a half seconds left to go here in this one. It's been a close game. 48 shots for the Black Bears, and you know, the initial reaction could be, oh, why was this game so close? Well, Delaware's playing really good. They played the last two out of the last three times they played the Black Bears. It's been two goal affairs, and right now it's a one goal affair. Martin, I believe, might have just gotten barely a piece of that one as it ends up behind the net.
Brooks, I think he just whiffed on it, ironically enough, ending up better because it's very rare for a goalie to whiff on a puck and say it ended up better for their team.
Josh Newberg taking his sweet time getting up to the faceoff dot. Always tries to be the last man in. Wins the faceoff. Walters carries the puck in front of his own net. Mac Lewis gets it over to Kirkby. Kirkby's on sides, dangles around one, puts it in the empty net. Black Bears up by two.
And Brooks also giving a little bit to Kirkby on the way past for the goal. Tyson Kirkby doing an excellent job settling the puck, making sure that it's a good goal scoring opportunity for him to put the, don't want to say closer, but the closer in the back of the net.
33 and a half seconds left to go, and the Black Bears up by two. For the second night in a row, Binghamton scores 8 goals.
Still some 16-point weekend for the Black Bears, Brooks.
Face-off won back by the Black Bears. Lewis will get to a loose puck, and Kirkby will skate away with it behind the net. Tries to shelf one just to add one more. And now 20 seconds left to go in this one. Hannah Kynan through the neutral zone to Vellstrom. Vellstrom circles back over as Movali dumps it in for what could be the final time. McVay coming way out of his crease to play that one. And the Black Bears are going to skate away with 6 points this weekend. Josh Newberg never gave up on the play. And the Binghamton Black Bears are officially 1-0 on Star Wars night.
Yeah, and Brooks, an excellent job by the Black Bears closing this one out. Short and bench due to some injuries and some penalties on them. It's going to be interesting to see what Coach Grant Sherwood says after the game on the discipline of the team. An excellent win nonetheless. You leave the weekend with 6 points on the table, but a lot of questions loom for the Black Bears. The health of Tyler Jurich. What's going to happen to your top line where, you know, he's out for any sort of period of time. Already saw Cam Yarwood go down with a lower body injury. It's going to be interesting to see, Brooks, as the week unfolds, what's the news that comes out about this team.
Black Bears win by a final count of 8-6. We're getting the Budweiser 3 stars here momentarily. All three do belong to the Binghamton Black Bears as we try to get the final stats coming across the line. Here, there's one, if I believe I'm right there. The first star, not really in question tonight. I think everybody back at home can take a good guess over who it's going to be. And before we send it to commercial one more time, we're going to let our ringside reporter, Cole, get set up, grab one of his interviews. And Alex, quickly, before we let Cole get set up, good bounce back outing in the third period for the Black Bears when they face some adversity.
Yeah, 100%, Brooks. The Black Bears kept leaving the screen door a little bit open for the Thunder, but when it mattered most, they slammed it shut.
Tyson. Kirkby will be one of the stars, as they announce here.
Tell you what, Brooks, that throw looks like a Josh Allen touchdown pass. Perfect spiral from Tyson Kirkby.
All right, those were the Budweiser three stars of the game. And now we join our ringside reporter, Cole, who is standing by. Who you got there, Cole?
I'm here with tonight's third star, Matt Lewis. Matt, you guys put up 8 goals last night, another 8 tonight. What has it been about this offense that's got it clicking these last 2 nights?
I think the talent's always been there. It's coming together now. I'm seeing 4,000 plus people there tonight really got us going. So, you know, we owe it to the fans, and we just finally started to play.
That's what I was about to ask you, Matt. You got a whole bunch of people here tonight. What is having a nearly full arena do for a team energy-wise and motivation-wise?
It's unbelievable. I mean, there's no other team in the league that can draw this amount of fans. And just the community supporting us means a lot to us, so let's keep rolling.
And Matt, before I let you go, I think everyone will be angry if I don't ask you. What do you guys think of the new threats?
Congratulations to Mac Lewis and the rest of the Binghamton Black Bears as they win this one by a final count of 8-6. Don't forget that the post-game auction is coming up. If you're listening around the concourse right now, go ahead and head over to Section 1 or near the center ice area to live bid on the Star Wars jersey auctions, fresh off the players' backs. We're going to take a timeout, come back with the La Quinta Inn and Suites post-game show after these messages. You're listening to Black Bears Hockey on Fox Sports 1430 Binghamton.